anything else can strike anywhere, leaving your family vulnerable. That's why you can't afford to be without emergency food supplies. If you're like most people, you know that you need emergency food supplies, but you keep putting it off. So, to help you, Ready Reserve Foods is offering a free sample kit of emergency food so you can test our food for yourself. The food really is free. You simply pay for the shipping and we'll send you the food for free. To get your free sample kit of emergency food, simply call 800-453-2202 or visit ReadyReserveFoods.com. Again, that's 1-800-453-2202 or ReadyReserveFoods.com. Don't wait. Call now because the free sample kits are limited. So call 800-453-2202 or ReadyReserveFoods.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We are December 9th, 2011 on this Friday edition. We're going to be here for the next 3 hours, and we're going to have a special edition of InfoWars Nightly News this evening. I'm just going to leave it at that. We have Lindsey Williams joining us in 30 minutes because in the hour and 20-minute interview we had with him, it wasn't enough to cover all the points he was making. So I've got him on for 30 minutes in the second half of this hour to go over what his former oil company CEO, globalist insider, told him on the religious front. And I know who the person is. I know Dr. Monteith's talked to the exec as well. And it's just another insider. And most of the info's turned out to be pretty accurate over the years. A lot of it's stunningly accurate. And it deals with Iran and a lot more. William says, his source says, the attack won't come until next September or October as an October surprise for the election on Iran, but that it will happen. Now we have Ynet News, a big Israeli publication headline, risk of Israel-U.S. strike on Iran has tripled. So we'll cover that when we come back from break. Also, Dr. Steve Pachinik, who wrote the book on psychological warfare for the State Department, the CIA, and has overthrown world leaders, he'll be joining us for about 30 minutes in the next hour. Then I'll cover news and take your calls, dealing with the fact that he believes the United States is trying to start a civil war. Aaron, you can go ahead and bring that in. Thank you. In Pakistan, in the larger strategy, that's what General Hamid Ghul thinks they're doing as well, former head of Pakistani intelligence. I had asked Aaron, because I ran out of time, I'd forgotten to get this, to run over to the other studio on the other side of the office and get this for me, because this is also crazy, because I've seen a lot of other things going on. And driving in this morning, I was listening to San Antonio Radio, AM, but mainline neocon, and then I tuned in to 93.7 rock and roll, scanned through the dial, and it was a ad for don't end up in a FEMA camp, get storable food today. Don't go to the refugee camp to get the food, which is actually true. That's how they sell the camps in the first phase, is, oh, they're emergency centers for the society collapsing. We always said that's how they do it. It's how the Nazis did it. And sure enough, in the Emergency Centers Establishment Act, it says all that. They're not just going to come out and say, hi, we're wearing Nazi uniforms and swastikas, and we're going to, you know, first they start shutting down the society, shutting down their competition. They bring in a depression by design for certain groups, lock down certain city areas, and then start arresting people. First questioning and releasing, putting their hands on you, cuffing you, getting normal law-abiding citizens accustomed to being picked up by the police. That's what the drills at the schools are all about. So that when they finally pick you up to take you away forever, you don't resist. It's all a psychological warfare program. And it trains the cops to always put their hands on citizens who aren't in the criminal class. And to take blood and to taser people and to ban protest. And all of this is a program. A psychological warfare program. But when I saw this news last night, we had Stuart Rhodes on about it. It was amazing because I also found a News Channel 5 story that was totally separate in Tennessee, mainstream TV, one of the big stations in the state, reporting that the state under federal auspices is going door to door asking if you have storable food. And the state means well, because Stewart's talked to some of the state police involved. And then they give it to the feds, and the feds put you on a list. And then separately, they confirmed at a storable food outfit in Tennessee that the feds came in without a warrant and said, give us your full list, and they wouldn't. So they basically blew up and left and said, we're coming back. So something's going on with this food thing. And we'll be right back. It's just a big transmission lined up today. Stay with us.
Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty, and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at InfoWars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Attention shoppers, please stay in line. You must be scanned and searched before entering the mall area. Attention, you must disrobe and pass through the scanner at mall security before entering the building.
Hey, most GCN listeners know that the future of Christmas shopping may quite well be that scary. And while we're not there yet, as shoppers, we still face terrible traffic, crazy lines, and even crazier shoppers. But this year can be different. You can still opt out of the craziness and do your shopping off the grid by going to offthegridchristmas.com, where you'll find our new Christmas video featuring an amazing assortment of truly hard-to-get gifts. Gifts you simply won't find in stores. These are gifts that can help anyone on your list become better prepared for the hard times ahead. And here's the best part. Prices have been slashed until December 15th. This year, opt out of the lines. You won't get fined. You'll get great discounts on all kinds of off-the-grid gear by going to offthegridchristmas.com. Go to offthegridchristmas.com. That's offthegridchristmas.com.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are live and we're going to be here for the next 3 hours. We have a jam-packed broadcast lined up for you today. Coming up in 30 minutes, we didn't have time to finish our amazing discussion with Lindsay Williams yesterday, so he'll be with us for 30 minutes. Then Dr. Steve Pachinik, former head of psychological warfare at the State Department and running CIA operations overthrowing major world leaders, and of course the co-author of many of Tom Clancy's books and film producer in his own right, will pop in for about 20, 30 minutes to give us his take on the fact that the West is trying to start a civil war in Pakistan. General Hamid Ghul, former head of Pakistani intelligence, who ran the Afghan war against the Soviets successfully, pretty much concurs with that. last week when he was on. And, of course, our weekly visit with Bob Chapman. We'll look at the euro, gold, the dollar, and a lot more today, and jam in some of your phone calls. Now, I just got a call right as I was going live today, and then during the break I talked to Derek, one of our sales guys, and he said, man, eFoodsDirect.com, one of our big sponsors, great storable foods outfit that I use, is just getting hammered with calls about the press reports of the feds going into storable food facilities and asking for the list, demanding the list of who's getting storable food. And they just wanted us to relay to you that that's not happened to them, but that they're being hammered. Their phone systems are melting down with calls. And of course, they would be the first to tell you if that did happen. And they are the biggest in the country. See, the feds know that a big outfit that's Patriot will go public. They're creeping around. And what's incredible, this is confirmed. Tennessee News, it's called The News Channel 5. In fact, we'll pull up the article in a little while. I haven't even given these to the guys yet. They're reporting that, the Tennessee conducts door-to-door preparedness checks to ask about your storable food. And then Oath Keepers has an alert that's up at Infowars.com. Federal agents demand customer list from Mormon food storage facility. I'm going to get Kurt Nemo to integrate the News Channel article and this one and do our own, because there are executive orders about food confiscation during emergencies. Well, I mean, they can sign executive orders and then they've got them on the books for gun confiscation. They're criminals. The government in the past, the Supreme Court has said that they could sterilize Native Americans in the 30s and that black people weren't human. I mean, our government for a while was linked up with Hitler. Just because these crooks have a bunch of paramilitary goons who think it's cool to go after people's food supply. Raw milk's not evil. Storable food's not bad. The Amish aren't bad. The government's bad. People running this government are bad. I mean, there's more news, and Holder has been caught perjuring himself. And he says, nobody lied at the DOJ. That's a quote. And here's a headline. He says it has nothing to do. He went on to say it has to do with your state of mind. So he says no one is lying, and it has to do with your state of mind. These are people caught shipping guns into Mexico, drugs back into the country, and laundering the money. New York Times last Sunday finally admitted it. AFP on Monday. And he gets up there and says, I didn't lie. DOJ didn't lie. It meant our intent, our state of mind. We weren't trying to lie. Of course, they said they weren't trying to blame it on the Second Amendment. Those memos have been made public by CBS 2 days ago. We wrote a more detailed article at Infowars.com. So they are a pack of criminal liars. Tyranny is when the government hijacks the population. It's when the government is taken over by criminals. And it happens in every case to every culture. No empire and no nation has ever lasted more than 235 years. You betcha we are the record holder. America, the United States, is long in the tooth. And criminals have taken over all the major power positions. Corzine went in and said, I don't know where the money went. When he gave the orders to take the private accounts and then resigned. I mean, do you get it? They'll do anything. And why? Because all of the federal regulators are his former employees. The head of the CFTC is his former right-hand man who was invested in MF Global and has disappeared. And no one in the mainstream media is saying, why has he disappeared? Where is the money? It's just, well, we're going to learn from this. So the money's gone. Okay, well, thank you. Thank you, Ms. Corzine. Well, thank you very much. Yes, I don't know where it went. They're like, oh, that sounds very reasonable. Thank you. And you've got Holder up there saying, I didn't lie to you. Okay, we did know, but we didn't mean to lie when we lied. I mean, do you get it, folks? These are dangerous criminals who run Homeland Security, and they will stage terror attacks. You better believe that. In fact, there's a new announcement. They're out today. Homegrown terrorists are going to strike, and Homeland Security says their new main focus is domestic right-wing groups, and the right-wingers are going to blow stuff up any minute. We've got to arrest them because the right-wingers exposed us shipping guns into Mexico and are stealing money. That's what's really happening. Is the Patriots know who these crooks are, have studied them, and have been on top of this. And now our credibility is going straight up like a Saturn rocket. Okay? Heavy lifting right into orbit. above these criminals. We've got the high ground. They know it. They don't like it. So what are they going to do? They're going to start wars. They're going to blow stuff up and blame it on domestic groups and sick the paramilitary steroid heads on us. And that's not going to work either. So, it is just disastrous. Let's go ahead and play part of the exchange on C-SPAN yesterday with Eric Holder up there. Caught lying, memos all public, shipping guns into Mexico, and then blaming the Second Amendment for it. A false flag caught red-handed that has killed hundreds of people, including three police officers and three Border Patrol agents. Confirmed. Confirmed so they could blame the Second Amendment. It was never about tracking the guns and tracking the drug money. The banks that run this country, oh, they sure track the drug money. Absolutely. They run the entire operation, including the aircraft shipping the drugs in. Source Bloomberg, AP Reuters, $376 billion in a two-year period. Wachovia, Wells Fargo. Running the giant aircraft, leasing them, paying for them, running the aircraft. The war on drugs is to bust anybody shipping in large quantities that isn't laundered through the globalist operation. Period. End of story. You know what? Let's just go ahead and go to this clip. Here it is.
What are you going to do to clean up this mess?
Well, first, let me make something very clear, and in response to an assertion that you made.
Hit pause, back it up. I'm going to start over again. Notice even the toughest questions he got from that particular congressman is, how are you going to clean up this mess? That's like asking a rapist that busts in a house and rapes a woman he's lusting after and knocks her teeth out and shoots her in the head, and the cops show up. There's a dead woman there, and they say, how are you going to clean up this mess? Like it's a mess. He intended to engage in this crime. It isn't a mess. It isn't an accident. It isn't, oh, gee, I didn't build this five-story balcony correctly, and my wife went out there, and it fell, and she died, and so I get an involuntary manslaughter charge for negligence. That's not what we're talking about. We're not talking about cleaning up a mess. We're talking about dirt bag criminals staging a terror attack of guns on our country in Mexico to blame the Second Amendment, caught red-handed by these terrorists. These are terrorists. Go back to the terrorist. Go back to him.
What are you going to do to clean up this mess?
Well, first, let me make something very clear. And in response to an assertion that you made or hinted at, nobody in the Justice Department has lied.
Nobody. Why was the letter withdrawn?
The letter was withdrawn because there's information in there that was inaccurate.
Oh, man!
The Justice Department letter of February.
Okay, well, tell me what's the difference between lying and misleading Congress in this context.
Well, if you want to have this legal conversation, it all has to do with your state of mind and whether or not you had the requisite intent to come up with something that can be considered perjury or a lie. The information that was provided in that February 4th letter was gleaned by the people who drafted the letter after they interacted with people who they thought were in the best position to have the information.
Okay. Now the wagon.
Stop right there. They ordered subordinates who weren't part of the program to write a letter. That'd be like if the cops came here to question, let's say, me for a hit and run they think I hypothetically was involved in. And they're here to interview Alex Jones, and I won't talk to them. I just say, go talk to the secretary. And then, of course, the secretary is going to go, I don't know if 2 weeks ago Alex Jones ran over somebody and drove off from the scene. And then it turns out that I did run over the person. And then they're sitting there going, well, that was because the people who were involved didn't know anything about it. That's right. And you had people, when you were subpoenaed by Congress, go and lie for you who supposedly weren't involved. And it turns out you have publicly said you didn't know. And now it's known that you did know. And that Janet Reno Napolitano, that's right, Miss Napolitano, Mrs. Janet Napolitano, I'm sorry, confused with Janet Reno, same type of criminal creature, same clone, whatever, off the same devil's apple cart. Here they are. Here they are. Just in everybody's face, lying. And the memos, CBS has them. Oh, we're going to do this and blame the Second Amendment. Won't it be great? Yeah, what a bunch of dirtbag crooks. And if you don't think these people won't stage terror attacks, that attorney general was the deputy attorney general when Oklahoma City happened and was in it to his eyeballs. He's a very dangerous person. That's a hardcore criminal. People are like, that's shocking to say. Hey, they ship guns into Mexico to blame it on the Second Amendment. Okay, let's finish up the clip as we go to break. We'll come back. Here it is.
Now, that's a question of because there have been inconsistent submissions to Congress. You know, you yourself testified that you'd only heard about it a few weeks earlier, and then in November you said it probably was a few months. As late as October 7th, in response to the allegations that you lied on May 3rd, you wrote to Congress your statements on...
All right, we'll come back with more of these dangerous terrorists. And look, those aren't just words. These are terrorists caught.
Optics Planet, the go-to store for everything tactical, military, survival, and hunting, has redefined member privileges with a new exclusive online store featuring discounts too large to show the public. Optics Planet is proud to present Devor.com. That's DVOR.com. Devor is a members-only store with limited-time deals, not normally found at Optics Planet. We're talking 3 days or less. We're talking exclusive. We're talking up to 90% savings on the gear you want and need. Devor.com. Are you a member yet? The prices on Devor are so low our vendors won't let them be posted publicly, so you have to sign up to see the deals. Now through December 23rd, use the coupon code RADIO to save $10 off your first purchase at Devor.com, or use the coupon code GCN to save 5% off most purchases at OpticsPlanet.com.
HempUSA.org has moved and expanded its operations for faster worldwide shipping. Our product line has grown from 5 to nearly 100 items in less than 5 years. Our food is grown naturally, always chemical-free, not found in stores. Great for daily intake and perfect for your emergency storage shelter. Call 908-691-2608 or visit HempUSA.org and see what our powder, seeds, and oil can do for you.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. I'm placing a silver dollar in a book explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
There are limitless ways to go into business for yourself, but most involve substantial capital and risk. Our InfoWarsTeam.com operation is different. We promote premium quality health, energy, and skincare products using dynamic, caring personalities and state-of-the-art media technology to spread a powerful message of health, wealth, longevity, and freedom. This low-cost business opportunity is designed for full-time or part-time, so you can work as little or as much as you'd like. It is you that defines the reward level. Whether you are seeking a few hundred extra dollars per month or a six or even seven figure annual income, it's up to you. Want to find out more? Shoot an email with InfoWars Team in the subject line to InfoWars Team Coordinator MZ and tell him a little bit about yourself. That's the initials MZ at InfoWarsTeam.com. That's MZ at InfoWarsTeam.com. I only promote products that I truly believe in, and these are phenomenal. Whatever you do, visit InfoWarsTeam.com.
From the shattered Rust Belt come the Lost Vegas.
Now also available in digital format at Amazon and iTunes worldwide.
Don't come calling when your walls start falling down.
Life Before the Collapse by the Lost Vegas on 180-gram vinyl and mastered especially for vinyl by legendary audio engineer Steve Hall. Life Before the Collapse by the Lost Vegas.
The Lost Vegas.
Now available at Amazon.com.
And iTunes.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back live, and we're tracking this out-of-control criminal government that does whatever it wants, whenever it wants, however it wants. And again, it's not fun. This is not a game. It's not a joke. We have a government that ships guns into Mexico to get people killed so they can take our guns away. That is terrorist. Face it. And driving into work this morning, I saw not one, not two, not three, not four, but five state police cars in a 20-minute drive writing people tickets. And I watched them. They were pulling cars over there. Might have been going 5-6 miles over the speed limit. I mean, it is so incredible to see this kind of stuff going on. It is so amazing to see this type of garbage. Here they are nickel and diming people. While they have a completely criminal government, and it's on record that illegal aliens across the United States are above the law, and the state police all over the country just leave them alone. And the state police have admitted it to my face. But while the citizens have the book thrown at them so that the state of Texas could buy a $600,000+ 34-foot speedboat to interdict criminals on Texas waterways. We sent a crew out yesterday when they were showing it off to the media. You could buy 6 boats, I went and looked it up, that were as big as this and almost as fast for the same price. But why not? They've got plenty of money. Why not have $10 million helicopters everywhere harassing people? While mafia government sits there and robs the daylights out of everybody. That's the same all over the country. You hear about small town mayors giving themselves $800,000 a year. You read about this stuff and it just goes on and on and on and on and on. Let's go ahead and finish up with the clips done. We played all of it where he's up there saying nobody at the DOJ has lied. And he says it has to do with your state of mind. I mean, just the arrogance of these people. And then look at this article out of USA Today. White House unveils new strategy to combat homegrown terror. The White House unveiled a strategy Thursday aimed at battling homegrown terrorism that emphasized better coordination with local authorities. The United States has made significant progress in degrading al-Qaeda's capabilities, who they put in charge in Libya and get on airplanes. I mean, it's just pure bull when you know about this stuff. President Obama noted today that 22 of the top 30 al-Qaeda operatives have been killed or captured under his watch. Intelligence officials suspect the terror organization is increasingly focused on seeking U.S.-born collaborators to carry out attacks. And it goes on to say they're now looking at domestic groups and fighting. The strategy has broad outlines for fighting extremism. And then you go through the national security strategy, and it's the libertarians, the gun owners, the returning veterans, yada, 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 the normal deal. Shifting the whole thing over now, as you see with the TSA, PSAs, where every terrorist is a white person clean cut, and every person reporting them is a so-called minority. We're already basically the majority in this country, all the quote minorities together. So, and they admit, yes, we're rebranding. So first they sold to white people, all the brown people are terrorists. You go to the police shooting ranges, you know, that's who they're shooting, people in turbans or brown-skinned people in the little pop-ups. And then now that, because white folks are like, well, at least it didn't, you know, us. We're not really racist, but still, at least it's not a white guy. I mean, you know, brown guys are a little bit different than us. And now it's, okay, well, now we're just going to say all the white people are terrorists, too. And so they're done. Everybody's a terrorist. Nobody can be trusted except the government. They're going to take our rights away to fight the terrorist when they're not getting the underwear bomber on the airplane confirmed. Congressional testimony when they're not protecting Major Hassan for 2 years on record, when they're not getting the shoe bomber on, just mentally ill patsies, or when they're not shipping the guns into Mexico to then destabilize things and blame the Second Amendment. I mean, there it is. And imagine what else is going on with these people. It's incredible. And now in Tennessee, they're going door to door, and they went to a Mormon cannery That's part of the Mormon religion, is be prepared. And they you know, they sell to locals who come there. And they went there, and it's reported Oath Keepers has learned that federal agents recently visited Latter-day Saints Mormon Church food storage cannery in Tennessee, demanding customer lists, wanting to know the identity of Americans who were purchasing food storage from the Mormons. This incident was confirmed by Oath Keepers, Tennessee chapter president Rand Cardwell. Here is Rand's report, and it goes over it. And then I've got Channel 5 News. Channel 5 News in Tennessee reporting basically the same stuff. I mean, there's no end to this criminal government. We'll be right back.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. This holiday season, more than half of our nation is in need of help due to the shattered economy. So now is the time to express the holiday spirit more than ever. Consider helping those you love with the most important gift, a supply of delicious, easy-to-fix, and very storable foods from eFoodsDirect.com. Their holiday gift and family packs start at $99 for a 16-day supply. While their 5-week supply of quick and easy to fix meals includes a personal backpack in case of a grab and go emergency. Order their combo gift pack and you'll save hundreds, plus get free shipping on your entire order. Call eFoods today at 800-409-5633 or visit them online at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex to find the special. That's 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
You may be arrested and or subject to other police action.
Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide. This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back live, and I have just gone into absolute anger mode by what's happening. I mean, even behind the scenes, I am on the verge of exploding because our country has got a case of serious tyranny. And we have got to respond to it, and we've got to deal with it. Because now the criminals are being exposed, they're butchering the country, and they're making their move. Now, I wanted to get Lindsey Williams back on. I'm going to give you the floor, Lindsey, here. We only got you for 30 minutes. We didn't have time to finish yesterday. I want you to recap the latest point in Iran, the other 5 points, how it ties in, that your former oil company executive insider info you were given. And then I want you to get into the religious part of how the elite are operating, because I know they've taken over the World Council of Churches, National Council of Churches. I know they're putting their propaganda in at every level. I know all of that is happening. And I know they've taken over many of the churches. And so that's part of their program. When you say devil messiah, that means their counterfeit church that the Rockefellers have set up and others. So I want to just, until we go out, you know, to the end of the hour here, I want to let you roll here. You don't need to thank me or any of that, you know, normal pleasantries. Just get right into the 5 points, the Iran point, and then what they got into, what the elite believes is going to happen in 2012. Because I know who your source is. I know Dr. Monteith's talked to him and the other source, Ken Fromm, who's now died of cancer last year. And so I want to just hear from you what they have to say, because so much of what they've broken down has come true and unfolded. Lindsey Williams, thanks for being with us here on short notice from since yesterday.
I feel so honored that years ago God would have allowed me to be asked to be the chaplain to the elite of the world for a 3-year period, and then to keep in touch with these people over these years so that I could come here today on the Alex Jones Show and save you major heartache. If you had listened, you did it. Those of you who did listen to Mr. Ken Fromm before he died, If it's written on a piece of paper, it's worth the paper it's written on. You didn't lose one single penny in the MF global collapse and bankruptcy here the other day because you listened to what he said. This is how the elite can save you. These men are old, 70s and 80s. They are talking as old men. You will not lose a single penny in the dollar collapse. And I think it will be next year. From what they're telling me, you will not lose one penny in the dollar collapse. If you were just merely follow the guidelines of the things we're trying to tell you that the elite are telling me, the devil's messiah agenda, which I'm going to get into today, your family will not be corrupted. Your children will not suffer the onslaughts of this agenda in 2012. Because you have heard the truth right here on the Alex Jones Show, and you know what to do. Well, I'm going to try to do exactly what Alex just said. I'm going to try to give it as fast as I can. I'll begin, first of all, with Iran. I was contacted within the last week. This is only days ago. And my elitist friend let me know everything is going to happen with Iran. There is going to be a conflict with Iran, but it is not going to take place right now. Now, I know I'm sticking my neck out a long ways today. I have no choice. I must tell you what is being told to me so that you can prepare for what is going to take place. They want a conflict with Iran. Now, you remember 3 years ago, I went to Mr. Fromm, and I said, is there going to be a conflict with Iran? He laughed over the phone and said, no, not for at least 2.5 years. Well, it happened exactly like he said. I'm telling you now, according to my elitist contacts, there is going to be a major conflict with Iran. It will probably take place well up into 2012. It is not going to happen this month, next month, or possibly the following month, even though we have our warships over there. Russia has their warships over there. Syria is a major issue. China has said, I will come to the rescue of Syria if NATO goes in. Iran has said that they will go to the rescue of Syria if we do anything over there. So that puts China, Russia, Iran, the United States of America, on a collision course. I know it's right now so touchy. They showed a picture of our drone. They actually captured the drone that we sent over Iran and showed a picture of this thing that it is a stealth drone. Unbelievable. My son showed it to me on the Internet last night. All of these things are being done to harass, intimidate, every way they can to get Iran upset because They do not want Israel to shoot the first shot. They do not want the United States of America to have the shot that was heard around the world. They want to harass and intimidate and anger Iran to the point that Iran will do the first, and then it came out as to why. You know, sometimes it's really not what the elite do as much as it is the reason why they do it. And the reason why they're going are doing what they're doing in Iran, why don't they do it to North Korea? Why don't they take on other nations who have the bomb? Why is it that they pick on Iran so much? Why is that the number one issue right now? The reason why is the thing that is so important. Let me read it again. It is, oh, people, please, you must shout this across this nation. I'm so glad that I have the privilege of being on one of the most prominent conservative radio talk show host program today, Alex Jones and Genesis Network, that is doing such a marvelous job, because I have the opportunity to let millions of people know today, folks, you must stop this president of ours. You positively must know what the agenda is whereby he is connected with the elite, and what the elite have told me about Iran is connected with what he plans to do. He's in trouble right now. His ratings are down. The economy is in shambles. The unemployment lines are getting longer and longer. And I want to read to you, you've got to know this. And whenever you see it happen, I hope it will enrage you.
Okay, but Lindsay, I want you to go over all that. But in the time we've got, I'm going to let you take us out to break here. So I'm turning my mic off and, you know, sitting back, because it's hard for me not to jump in because my brain burns with, you know, points I want to make. Get into the religious angle and what their devil messiah is, because that's the point you didn't get to yesterday.
Yes, there is a... All right, let me try to find the word here right quick. Okay, the elite have a think tank. And back about 5 or 6 months ago, I was given the 5 agendas of the elite for the year 2012, and I was so startled until I didn't do a single radio talk show for over 2 months. I couldn't. I was scared to death of what I had. And one of them was the devil's messiah. Now, you've heard me speak of this before, because when Mr. Fromm and I were on the phone together back 2 or 3 years ago, he used the expression one day, devil's messiah, and I couldn't quite understand what he was saying. And I didn't understand it fully until now, and you'll see it during 2012. Folks, please, 2012 will be the most eventful year in 2,000 years, and one of them is because of the devil's messiah program. And Mr. Fromm used that expression, and I said, Ken, what are you talking about? And he went on to explain, it is not a part of the book of Revelation. It has nothing to do with the Antichrist. Rather, it is the program whereby they had to demoralize America by removing the God that made America great from our society before they could bring in the new world order. They have amazingly succeeded through our schools, through our churches, 501c3 for the church, for the schools. They put in evolution so that people would think they were evolutionized animals and act like them. They've brought in the drug craze. They've gotten us in war after war. They've demoralized our nation and brought us to the point where they could bring in that immoral program, which is devil's messiah. And this coming year, 2012, they have an agenda that is accelerated to the devil's messiah program. It is so startling. Until when I tried to put this in the DVD, I really couldn't say it. The words would not even properly describe what these people were doing. We actually had to show it in about 10 to 15 minutes of DVD clips in order to explain to you what the devil's messiah program is. And it basically is, during 2012, they have certain goals that they're going to bring in. One of them is to bring our nation to the point that we will beg for, plead for, and want the new currency and the new world order. And part of doing it is to so demoralize the nation that we'll have no conscience whatsoever as to what we should do morally. So the devil's messiah program is a demoralization program for the year 2012, accelerated during that year. Now, when we were on set doing this new DVD, 2012, The Beginning of the End, I asked an individual to be with me who is one of the outstanding financial advisors of America. And right on the set, I didn't know he was going to do this, right on the set, he said, wait a minute, Chaplain. He said, my son experienced this the other day. I said, what are you talking about? He said, my son always homeschooled him. He said, we moved out of the city and into the country. We thought that in a smaller town environment, we wouldn't have to put up with what we put up with in the city, so we put him into public school. He said, my son, he's a teenager, by the way. He said, he came home the other day, and he said, Daddy, I got to tell you what I saw. He said, we were forced to watch it. He said, we had no choice. It appeared on the television. He said every classroom in America that has a television showed this. And he said it was the President of the United States of America talking about the very thing that I've heard you talk about. And he went on to tell me what the President of the United States of America was saying, and we've got it on this new DVD recorded so you can see it, what the President of the United States of America said about the demoralization program, the devil's messiah agenda, which I was... You will not hear this expression, devil's messiah, from any of the news media. It is their personal code words for their program of demoralization of the United States of America. It is even being promoted by the President of the United States of America in the classrooms of our country. And you are going to be faced with a demoralization program for you and your children in 2012 that will bring us to the point that people will no longer have a conscience to turn down the new world order system, folks. You must be guarded against it. Now, let me tell you why 2012 is so vitally important to this. And this, again, goes back to the think tank of the elite. And when I was told this 4 or 5 months ago, it startled me so much, I started doing my own Bible study. Why is it that 2012 is so important? Now, it's not the Mayan calendar. That is not the only reason. Yes, don't take the Mayan calendar for granted. After all, that was a very advanced culture for their time. And they did develop a calendar. And I think it's December the 21st of 2012, they bring this present dispensation to an end and start a brand new one. Now, don't take that for granted, but that is not what it's based on. The elite. And I'm sorry to have to say this, but in many instances, the elite know more about prophetic scriptures than what the average pastor does. And I say that having been a pastor of a church for 12 years myself. The think tank of the elite have come to the conclusion that in 2012, there are going to be some divine manifestations. But whenever I tell you why they came to this conclusion, pastors, I have never heard this in any pulpit in America. I never gave it myself. I never saw it until this was told to me back a few months ago. And when I saw it, I was utterly dumbfounded. Here it is. I'll give it as quickly as I can. And Alex, again, thank you so much for kind of giving me the floor here, because you're right. I have a lot to say. Why 2012 and not the year 2000? There's a very definite reason why. Everybody, I mean, nearly every Christian I know, myself included, when the year 2000 came around, I knew something was going to happen in the divine realm. I'm not talking about the coming of Christ. I'm talking about some events in the divine manifestation realm. But it didn't happen. Nothing took place. And I must admit, I was disappointed, because I know that from the Old Testament, that from Adam until Christ was 4,000 years. I mean, there's no question about knowing this. Go to the genealogies of the Old Testament. You'll find it for yourself. We know that from Christ and until the year 2000 was approximately 2,000 years. It might have been give or take a little bit because the Roman calendar is off, but not much. Now, I must go to the scriptures. Please write this down. This is exactly what the elite know. They've got this down pat. They know it's going to happen. 2 Peter, in the New Testament, in God's holy word, 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 8, it says, One day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. Please read the context, all of you. Get your Bibles. Open them up after the program. Don't you change that dial now. And after the program, open them and look for yourself at the context of 2 Peter 3:8, and you'll find out that it's talking about a relationship between the 6 days of creation in the book of Genesis and what God's timetable is. In 6 days, he created the heavens and the earth. The seventh day rested. We know the seventh day is likened unto the millennium of 1,000 years. Now, you take the other 6,000, and what do you have? It brings us up to the year 2000. If a day is as 1,000 years and 1,000 years is as a day in the mind and the type, the way that God thinks, well, where does that place us? It places the year 2000. And this is the reason that many of us thought that something would take place in the year 2000, but it didn't. And I was disappointed. The elite know why something's going to take place in 2012. I ask you the question, for lack of time, to give the explanation. Please get the link, the explanation, on our DVD series, 2012, The Beginning of the End. And why is it happening in 2012? There's a reason why. At what age did the ministry of Jesus Christ begin? It did not begin at his birth. His birth was very insignificant. It was in a manger, in a stable, and nobody came to it except the shepherds. Now, the wise men didn't come until approximately 2 years later. Read your Bible, folks. I know at Christmas time they've got the wise men and shepherds all out on the church lawn in a scene, but it's not true. Look at your Bible. You'll find out that the wise men came about 2 years later to a house to see a young child, and the only person that came to his birth was the shepherds. And when they came, it would not broadcast all over the countryside. Even the Alex Jones Show would have had it on. It had one back in those days. It was so insignificant. But when did the ministry of Jesus Christ begin? Please go to Hebrew tradition. It's called Bar Mitzvah. It's approximately 12 years of age.
And again, the globalists are completely obsessed with numerology, the occult, everything, and they've claimed 2012 is from the Mayans so that they can ignore the Bible, but they have other reasons, and it's true. The globalists are obsessed with the occult and the Bible, and this is what you were told by this individual. We'll finish this up in a short segment straight ahead. Stay with us.
Has the United States been discovered in the Bible?
Where does Islam fit in Bible prophecy?
Is the new world order world government?
These and other crucial end time questions are answered in the new DVD package, Understanding the End Time, from End Time Ministries. Jesus Christ said, "I tell you these things before they come to pass, so that when they do come to pass, you might believe." After you watch this 14-lesson DVD series, Understanding the End Time, you'll know more about Bible prophecy than the average seminary graduate. This DVD package normally sells for $280. But now is only $199. Order Understanding the End Time DVD package at endtime.com today for only $199 or call 1-800-END-TIME. That's 1-800-363-8463. 1-800-363-8463 or endtime.com.
Hello, I'm Alex Jones. Myself, my family, the InfoWars.com team want to relay to you and your families that we are intensifying our efforts against the globalist on every front. InfoWars.com is leading the fight against the technocrats. But we can't do that without your help. By getting the films, bumper stickers, and t-shirts at InfoWars.com, you will wake up people in your area and support our operation as we move to the next level. We need your help to spread the word like never before. They wish to hide themselves during this tectonic battle between the forces of freedom and darkness. You are the response to the globalist technocrats and their program of global eugenics dehumanization and ultimate extermination. The war is here. It's an info war. The spirit of 1776 versus the mindset of 1984.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
All right, Dr. Steve Pachinik is going to be joining us for 20 or 30 minutes. Then we've got Steve Shank coming on, the longest continually operating storable foods company in the nation, where I've gotten my storable foods. I bought them from three or four other places, and they were all terrible or old. This is fresh, quality, made in America. But the reason is they're getting flooded with phone calls, and they called us this morning, and I made some other calls. Other storable foods outfits are as well, because of an article out of News Channel 5, in Tennessee, door-to-door assessment for disaster preparedness, and amongst the 22 questions, because they don't list the questions here, but we've talked to the locals, they are asking, do you have storable food, firearms, stuff like that. It says 22 questions are asked. They may include, what is your primary way of getting information during a disaster emergency? What special assistance might you need from emergency responders? But this is being handed back to the feds. And then we have Oath Keepers confirming from their Tennessee head that and of course the group doesn't want to be named, but they've been there and confirmed it, that a Mormon cannery there, a smaller one, people go and buy storable foods, was visited by the FBI. So we don't know if this is isolated to this or if it's connected to this, but storable food is getting huge now. I mean, I heard it on a rock and roll station this morning, talking about don't go to a FEMA camp, be prepared. And we're going to talk to Steve Shank about it, because if he knows anything about this, and I've talked to him, there isn't any information, but he can speak to it generally. He'll be able to break it down for us when he pops in. And then Bob Chapman. Going back real quick, Lindsay, we're almost out of time here, and I appreciate you coming on. We'll have to check in with you in the near future again. Five, 6 months pass, and I just like in the twinkling of an eye, I'm like, wow, we got to get Lindsay Williams on. Yes, I mean, for those that study the Bible, if things are repeated over and over again, what happens in Ezekiel then manifests in another way. I know it's very complex, but theologians understand it, and it certainly does manifest itself. So finishing up with the timetable of why the elite from reading the Bible believe 2012 is such a big year.
2012 is the most eventful year in 2,000 years because of when Jesus Christ began his ministry, the prophets of the scriptures would have given anything to live in 2012. This is the most exciting year you'll ever live in. You remember at 12 years of age that Christ was taken by his parents to the temple, and in modern-day Hebrew tradition would have been called Bar Mitzvah. And when they went to get him and take him home, I want to read you his words. How is it that you sought me? Wished you not that I must be about my Father's business? At what year did Jesus Christ begin his earthly ministry? You have to hear the whole background to this. He began it at 12 years of age. 2000, nothing happened. Why is something catastrophic, the most unusual you've ever seen, going to take place?
Sure, you're saying at the end of his 12th year, about to become 13, that's why it's at the end of 2012 they think all this stuff is going to happen, because it's 6,000 years from Genesis with 12 years added on the end. That's basically what this former oil company CEO told you?
2012, there will be divine manifestations is what they're saying. I did not say divine intervention. You remember that when Daniel was thrown in the lion's den, the book of Daniel, God did not save him from the lion's den. Instead, he went to the lion's den with him. God's not going to come back and save you from the new world order. God's going to give you enough sense and understanding to know what to do so that you can live a normal life through what the new world order is going to give you. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the three Hebrew children, God did not keep them from going to the fire furnace. He went in the fire furnace with them.
What about the seven fat years and the seven lean, too?
Yes, and the king King went down into the fiery furnace, and he said, wait a minute, how many did I throw in there? And the soldier said, three. And he said, I see four down there, and the fourth is likened unto the Son of God. You are going to see, Alex, I guarantee you that you will have me on your program at least once a month interpreting what's happening in 2012. We're going to see some of the most unusual divine manifestations. You're going to see unusual devil's messiah programs. You're going to see unusual things about the financial world take place in 2012. It's going to fulfill so much of the scriptures, you will be amazed. You
wow.
do not have to suffer through this time.
Amazing. Lindsay Williams, thank you so much. We'll talk to you very soon.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
Have you ever wanted to give a gift that expresses faith in liberty, those powerful beliefs that shaped our nation at its founding? If so, pay close attention, because this may be the most important holiday message you'll hear this year. Beautiful Liberty Blankets are now available.
The Liberty Blanket is made right here in the USA out of all natural cotton. It's ultra soft, ultra warm, and designed to remind your friends and loved ones of the enduring values that won the battle for freedom in early America. The center of the Liberty Blanket has the words appeal to God, a phrase that Washington and the founders used often as they announced to the world that their rights and liberties came from a sovereign creator. And in each corner of the Liberty Blanket details one of the pillars of American freedom: education, church, civil government, and justice. Regularly $59.95, now just $39.95. It's the perfect Christmas gift that helps your friends and family remember our nation's most precious legacy. To order your Liberty Blanket, go to libertyblanket.com. That's libertyblanket.com, or call 800-209-1258. That's 800-209-1258.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back live. Wow, I have got so much news here. UN calls for eco-fascist world government at Durban Summit. I've got Lord Christopher Monckton joining us on the nightly news tonight to break that down. Also, they're saying James Cameron has vetoed the EU takeover of England, and he's being hailed as fighting the New World Order. I don't know what to make of this. But that's even the Daily Mail saying that. Yeah, world government's just out in the open now. It's, you type world government into the search engine and hit news, you'll see every day dozens of mainstream articles. Wow, it's crazy to be alive right now. Corzine is stunned that MF Global couldn't find missing funds. We're going to get into all of that. Mercosi, letter to EU, now is the time to strip countries of sovereignty. Americans leaving the U.S. in record numbers. They want to put AI systems in your car and cell phones that track everything you're doing. No more talking behind the wheel. Scientists develop a system that can shut down your cell phone while you're driving. That is something we're going to be breaking down. Also, some good news. You know, the globalists have declared war on the U.S. infrastructure and the European infrastructure, Australia, New Zealand, the globalist holdings. They're shutting down the wealthy West because we're their enemy. And then trying to move everything to third world nations where they totally control the population. Shutting down our power infrastructure, saying they want to. Post-industrial, harassing farmers, ranchers, premises ID, animal ID, harassing small meat packers. They've shut down most of them. They passed, well, the EPA came out and said, we now are going to fine you for hay. Hay is a pollutant. I'm not joking. You remember that earlier in the year. They said, any dust off hay, anything, $10,000 fines. And we're going to come in without warrants, and if there's dust, they have little meters, kind of like a cop pulling you over and checking your window tint. If there's dust in the air, $10,000 fines. Dust in a field. I'm not joking. Here is the Hill newspaper. Farm dust bill approved in House. The House on Thursday approved legislation Republicans said was aiming to ensuring the EPA cannot regulate so-called farm dust. Now, again, this is a military economic shutdown operation. And they tell the bureaucrats, go write more tickets, go harass more 18-wheeler drivers, go white glove inspect everybody or the government's going to collapse. And you go suck money out of everybody, shutting down commerce, and it all gets sucked out to the foreign banks because the states, the counties are all invested in the derivatives. You help implode things believing, I've talked to these cops, yeah, we tell us we got to double our quota because there's no money. There's no money. In a free market system, there's so much wealth and so much commerce, everybody gets rich, basically. Look what America became. But it's been reversed in the last few decades. The wealthiest country in the world. Our poorest people have been some of the wealthiest people per capita compared to other nations. All of those blessings are going out the door right now. Unbelievable. I was going to plug it now, but I'll plug it after the break as we go to Dr. Steve Pachinik. Now, more than ever, it's time to support Infowars.com. But more importantly, you get tools to wake people up. You can get all 18 of my films on DVD right now for $99.95. That's 70% off. All of them. And bumper stickers and a citizen rule book. You can get all of those. We got a lot of other films we're carrying as well, like Scientist Under Attack, Outside the Law, Stories from Guantanamo, and an excellent film on Oklahoma City, the only modern one I know of out there. A lot of eyewitness reports that we've got available for you right now. A Noble Lie, available at Infowars.com. So it's all available at Infowars.com. And if you order by the 19th, it's guaranteed delivery before Christmas. So you can do all your Christmas shopping at Infowars.com. We've got bumper stickers and citizen rule books at cost. Every order gets a free citizen rule book. You can order those in bulk as stocking stuffers. Yeah, we're not into the war on Christmas here. Sorry, I'm going to say it. Christmas. Sorry, it makes you mad out there. Control freaks trying to tell me what language to use. And then there's PrisonPlanet.tv. PrisonPlanet.tv. We've got a Christmas special we run every year. 44% off. I keep saying 40. It's 44% off a PrisonPlanet.tv membership right now. See the nightly news, everything. Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. This holiday season, more than half of our nation is in need of help due to the shattered economy. So now is the time to express the holiday spirit more than ever. Consider helping those you love with the most important gift: a supply of delicious, easy-to-fix, and very storable foods from eFoodsDirect.com. Their holiday gift and family pack start at $99 for a 16-day supply, while their 5-week supply of quick and easy-to-fix meals includes a personal backpack in case of a grab-and-go emergency. Order their combo gift pack, and you'll save hundreds, plus get free shipping on your entire order. Call eFoods today at 800-409-5633 or visit them online at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex to find the special. That's 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Okay, my friends, until about 40 after, Dr. Steve Pachinik joins us, frequent guest here on air. Then Bob Chapman's going to join us, but... at 40 after, we're going to have Steve Schenck on of eFoodsDirect.com, the biggest and longest continually operating storable foods company in the nation, because we ran a story yesterday. Oath Keepers reports and picked up articles out of News Channel 5 out of Tennessee where there's door-to-door assessment for disaster preparedness, and one of the things they're asking him with 22 questions we've talked to the folks is you have storable foods, firearms. It's a federal snooping operation. The state police, who Stewart and others have talked to, meanwhile, and the people they've got involved, meanwhile, but they're feeding it back to the feds. And then on top of that, Oath Keepers alert federal agents demand customer list from Mormon food storage facility. And of course, eFoods Direct's the biggest in the country. They're out in Utah. They're not affiliated with this group. And, of course, Stewart didn't release the name of the group because they're obviously a little concerned. So people are, like, running around trying to find out what group it is. We know who the group is. We haven't released the name, but we may do that or get them on air. So people are trying to find out, well, what group is this? They came in to the group. They said, we want your customer list. They said, no, get a we don't keep list. And, plus, you don't have a warrant. The feds got mad and left. So that's what's going on that front. And we're going to get an update from him because they've never had the feds visit them or ask for a list. But this has always been a concern. And it shows because it's confirmed they're going door-to-door asking about emergency preparedness. And they've got weird billboards up saying get prepared, but then listing it as a thing that's extremist, the Southern Poverty Law Center and others, to store food. So very bizarre that all of this is going on. But it fits into the bill being passed to have indefinite detention of American citizens, use the military domestically, KBR of Halliburton, now activating the FEMA camps, preparing the teams nationwide. We got those internal memos and the fact that they're getting the subcontractors ready. I'm not saying that they're going to execute this, but the point is they're getting it lined up and ready. And you notice there's warships in the Med, the Persian Gulf, Russia making threats, nukes being moved around, Pakistan threatening, Pakistan cutting off supply lines into Afghanistan, China's WHO, their president, saying we may have war with the United States, prepare for war 3 days ago. So this is super creepy. And then I have Ynet News out of Israel. One of their big publications, Risk of Israel, U.S. Strike on Iran has tripled. Senior risk analyst at Barclays Capital says chances of military operation increased from 5 to 10% to 25 to 30% in the past year. And then they also have another article here on this on Reuters. So we're going to get Steve Pachinik's update on all of this. Steve Pachinik, of course, co-wrote many of the books and was the advisor on the all-time best-selling military adventure novels. They're so realistic. Of course, with Tom Clancy, he's got MD in psychiatry from Harvard and also a PhD from Cornell Medical College. I think one of the only people to ever get both those at the same time. And I can't go over his illustrious bio. And he, of course, has worked on overthrowing foreign leaders. You name it. I mean, to try to get into it. Someday we got to get Steve Pachinik on about himself. He never wants to talk about himself. And any stories he can tell us just because they're so interesting. But StevePachinik.com, of course, helped us expose. And I've since talked to a national media figure and then talked to the individuals they put me in contact with at very high level in the current CIA. And they just said, we want to tell you you're right about bin Laden. Very bizarre. 3 weeks ago to have this person reach out to me just to say, I just want to tell you you're right about bin Laden. Very, very strange. to have that happen. And I'm just going to leave it at that. But there's a rebellion going on in the government right now against all this stuff that's happening. And that's pretty much been admitted. Steve Pachinik told us about it months ago. Dr. Pachinik joins us now. Doc, all this crazy stuff happening in Pakistan, what's really going on right now?
Well, yeah, I'm always glad to be on your show, Alex. And I've got to tell you how important your show is really going on. What's happening in Pakistan is we have literally created a civil war in Pakistan. And the attack of our killing 22 Pakistani officers is part of a long-term attempt by the CIA, not by our military, but the CIA, to create a government, a shadow government within Pakistan. And what we literally are doing in the Pakistani state is to divide the ISI, the Interstate Intelligence Unit, against each other, to push the military of the Pakistan against the civilians, civilians against civilians, because we no longer trust the prime minister or any element within the inter-service intelligence agency, which we created 20, 30 years ago to help us fight terrorism. So what's happened is we have used drones to kill Pakistani soldiers and others whom we felt have not been helping us. And we have created literally the American shadow state in Pakistan. We have gone in and created what's called the T unit within ISI. ISI is the inter-service intelligence and breaking and outsourcing of the CIA 20, 30 years ago to fight the Mujahideen. But the S unit of the ISI has been working with the military government and the prime minister to try to stabilize it. So we are now in a civil war that we've created by the CIA civilians under Panetta, and we have disrupted the entire state of Pakistan and breaking it down. Now, Pakistan, more than Iran or any other state, is the most dangerous country that we can take apart because of the nuclear bombs that are there and their ability to use it and the ability for them to break away from any central control. Now, even the CIA senior analysts, including Luis Riedel, who's one of the top CIA operatives, who created the plan for the Afghanistan-Iraq borders and having our soldiers in there, the CIA said, this is a bad situation going to worse. And one of our senior generals who was fired by Panetta and Obama, a distinguished admiral by the name of Dennis Blair, who's the director of national intelligence, said repeatedly, the CIA cannot run these drones continuously into Pakistan and CIA. That is not a covert operation. Covert is for a short period of time. A long period of time is a military action, and we have to have transparency, rules of engagement, and he was fired for that. So within the military, we are having a major war between the military, the army, the navy, and the civilians. The civilians are in control of an organization that is totally out of control now. And what's happening is the American public is paying $20 billion, $20 billion, just to pay off some of the warlords that we have to create in this secret government or the American shadow state in Pakistan. It is so serious that not one legislator has talked about it, not one Republican contender has talked about it, and of course, our president of the United States never mentioned it. And instead, he made this absurd comment that he killed Osama bin Laden. So what we have is disinformation, we have lying, and we have a war where our brave men and women are being killed for a strategy that makes no sense, an objective we could never reach, which is stabilize Pakistan. And instead, we have created our very own problem thanks to the CIA once again running the drones when, in fact, military superiors like Dennis Blair and others from SAFPAC have said we have to take over the drone activities in Pakistan and elsewhere in order to diminish the collateral damage. On top of that, to make matters worse, we now have lobbyists. You won't believe this, Alex. I know the audience won't believe this. Who are going around to lobby for a group called the MEK. The fancy name is Mujahideen, who are Iranian terrorists whom I fought against in the 1970s and 80s, who killed many of my operatives and civilians and contractors who worked for Khomeini, but Khomeini who took us hostage during the same period of time, never killed one of my hostages on the State Department. But the MEK, which did kill 6 to 10 of my people on the field in the 70s, have hired the following people to lobby this group to the Secretary of State, Clinton, to tell them to delist this terrorist group, the MEK, for money. So each one of the following people have received $30,000 to delist a terrorist group. There was Howard Dean and Governor Rendell, General Wesley Clark, General James Jones, CIA Director Woolsey, CIA Director Gross, and one of the greatest whores of all in the lobbyists is Fran Townsend, who you see on CNN repeatedly as a, quote, expert in counterterrorism. And then she was exposed last night by Anderson Cooper, which she's a CNN contributor, for also being a whore for lobbyists for a drug company in smallpox where they had nothing to do with it. Then we had Rudy Giuliani, all of whom were hired for $30,000 to $50,000. Mind you, this is a well-known terrorist group that has killed my people, our American people, and have been paid 30 years later to delist them from the terrorist group. So basically, we now have an industry where you can hire politicians and ex-politicians to use their prestige to say that that group, let's say Osama bin Laden, is not a terrorist or Al-Qaeda is not a terrorist. This is what's happening now in the United States.
Well, I mean, Steve... Dr. Steve Bochenek's our guest. We got to go to break. We're going to come right back. But it's like that everywhere. Look at MF Global, where he's the CEO. He takes the money, and he tells them, I don't know where the money went in front of Congress. The ATF's been caught shipping guns into Mexico, and the memos have now been released that they were going to blame it on the Second Amendment, and have. That's a false flag event. And now it's just government totally for sale. You've got the Solara Group. You've got $500 million given to an energy company that never even built anything. I mean, it is in a corrupt world, it's accelerating. We'll ask you why on the other side. And then there's proof of what you're saying about the CIA trying to cause a civil war. Riots in Pakistan for a secret deal with U.S. to pay $2.3 million blood money to free CIA agent who shot dead two men.
What happened, man? You used to be energetic, happy, and wow, did the ladies love you. Now you fall asleep on the couch, irritable and out of shape. Don't be that guy. Call now for a risk-free trial of Ageless Male, a natural supplement shown to raise testosterone by 61% and maintain healthy, normal levels. No injections, no appointments. With healthy testosterone levels, you can feel that energy again, that great outlook again, and yes, even a healthy sex drive. Right now, you can try Ageless Male risk-free. There's nothing to lose, guys. If you're a man who's noticed changes in your body, your mood, your sex life, call now for a risk-free trial of Ageless Male. Be the guy you used to be. Just call 1-800-497-8345. Don't wait another day. Just call 1-800-497-8345. That's 1-800-497-8345.
Hi, I'm Mark Craighead, founder of Crossbreed Holsters. I designed our top-selling holster, the Super Tuck Deluxe, to solve the problems of being poked, pinched, and gouged while carrying concealed. The Super Tuck Deluxe is the most comfortable, most concealable holster on the market today. We offer a 2-week free trial and a lifetime warranty.
Visit us at crossbreedholsters.com. Don't forget, crossbreedholsters.com.
That's the sound of your door being kicked in by an intruder with a single kick. That's the sound of the same door now protected by the Door Sentinel at MySafeDoor.com. Go to MySafeDoor.com right now and watch the amazing video. At MySafeDoor.com, you'll learn how to turn your home into a fortress with the Door Sentinel. 16 kicks later, and the Door Sentinel is still holding strong. MySafeDoor.com. That's MySafeDoor.com.
You don't need me to tell you that humanity is in a deep crisis. Everyone can feel it. We know a tectonic struggle is now taking place between the forces of freedom and those who love darkness, bondage, and enslavement. Yes, my friends, evil is rising. But take heart, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Recently, New World Order operative Hillary Clinton admitted they're losing the info war.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
The globalists are scared. They've overreached. The future of the info war is in your hands. Join PrisonPlanet.tv. Download the thousands of special video reports, ebooks, and more, and get them out to everyone you know. Continue to spread the word about the broadcast on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and every other globalist propaganda platform. We are going to use their system against them. The info war now goes into high gear.
In the event of an emergency, do you really trust Obama and the federal government to provide for you and your family? Modern-day emergencies like floods, tornadoes, earthquakes, snowstorms, terrorist attacks, or anything else can strike anywhere, leaving your family vulnerable. That's why you can't afford to be without emergency food supplies. If you're like most people, you know that you need emergency food supplies, but you keep putting it off. So, to help you, Ready Reserve Foods is offering a free sample kit of emergency food so you can test our food for yourself. The food really is free. You simply pay for the shipping and we'll send you the food for free. To get your free sample kit of emergency food, simply call 800-453-2202 or visit ReadyReserveFoods.com. Again, that's 1-800-453-2202 or ReadyReserveFoods.com. Don't wait. Call now because the free sample kits are limited. So call 800-453-2202 or ReadyReserveFoods.com.
Folks, we had General Hamid Ghul on, who the media has called the real head of Al-Qaeda. The point is, we've had him on five, six times over the years because a lot of people listen over in Pakistan, and he's a national figure there. And he said they're trying to start a civil war. But he went on to say that's probably what it is, and he gave evidence, but he said it is a crazy plan because it's only going to unify Pakistan, in his words. And he said, I don't like it, but now the military basically is running Pakistan. I want to get Dr. Steve Pachinik, who you could say at that same peer level as a counterpart to somebody like General Hamid Ghul, who's also a very crafty individual and intelligent. But here's Daily Mail, Associated Press, you name it. This is just last week, and then it happened again months before that. Riots in Pakistan after secret deal with U.S. to pay $2.3 million blood money to free CIA agent who shot dead two men. And they tried to claim diplomatic immunity, and he's out shooting people. It was also reported that he was trying to give uranium to some of the so-called Mujahideen tribal groups. Dr. Pachinik's a real expert on this. What do you make of that case with the CIA agent? What was his name? Raymond Allen Davis. What did you make of that situation? And of course, that's more credence to the destabilization program. And do you agree with Ghul that it's having the opposite effect?
Well, number one, I'm not a great admirer, as I've told you repeatedly over the years, because of the CIA inept there. I think one of the things I must say, that having worked for President Carter, who fired 4,000 CIA operatives, at the time I thought he was wrong. In retrospect, I think he was right. The CIA is totally out of control. Banana has been very inept in managing the CIA. The CIA is totally corrupt. They have no strategy. They're totally dysfunctional. Even as one of the senior officials has said, as I said, Bruce Rydell, who created the program, what they're creating is not only a nationalized program, what they're doing is destabilizing the entire area far beyond already in a failed state. So let me explain what that means. Pakistan is really a tribal area. They're not unified. There are 8 or 9 families that control the entire country and are totally corrupt. Benazir Bhutto was corrupt. Her husband, who's now the president of Pakistan, was in prison when I was there, and I worked with the senior official, Yaqub Khan, who put him in prison. And I have been working with the Islamic fundamentalists 20 years ago, where I went to school with them, and they were trying to make a revolution in a civil way. Now what happened, because there is no plan, the CIA has no objectives, and they're totally dysfunctional, that's why the military must take it over, they have created a dysfunctional state now. They won't be unified. I think the general is correct in certain ways. I think it's much more serious than that. I think they're going to be so fragmented because the AFTA, that's called the Federally Administered Tribal Zones, where we have a lot of problems, and hundreds of Pakistani soldiers were killed before Musharraf was in charge, and Musharraf gave us, the United States and the CIA, permission to come in and become a shadow state within the Pakistan. So you have to understand what that means. That means within our own country, we will have foreign troops to be a shadow state to try to destabilize every state from New York, the East Coast, all the way to California. There is no more Pakistan. What it is now, they're not going to unify. What will happen is they will fractionate, and then groups will take those bombs and use them at will wherever they need to because we can't control it. And what happens then, as our troops, our honorable warriors, have left Iraq and Afghanistan, and 100,000 will be leaving, they have spent their lives and their bravery for a strategy that makes no sense. In the meantime, the CIA took it over, destroyed Pakistan, trying to destroy Iran. That won't work. So we have two wars that are in effect going on at this particular point, but we call it covert operations. It's not a covert operation. They are literally wars. One is a civil war that we have created with this president.
All right, but let me ask you this then, Doctor. This is important. What is the strategy then in Pakistan?
What is what?
What is the strategy then? What do they think they're doing?
Strategy was that we were to take over the United States. The CIA wanted to take over the divisions of the ISI, which was called S Division. That's the term they used, which wasn't working with the United States to, quote, kill terrorists. Well, those terrorists were the Mujahideen that we created in Haqqani Group and Al-Qaeda were all that we created. In other words, we created our own mess 20 years ago. We go in there to try to clean up that mess, and instead, we created more of a mess. So we have no strategy. We have no focal point. You don't have a Kissinger. You don't have a Baker. You don't have a Schultz. You don't have a point of strategy where it says we need to stabilize the country in order to maintain stability. Instead, we've destabilized it. India's just waiting for it to be destabilized. China's backing.
Stay there, Doc. Stay there. Finish up when we come back.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
Attention GCN listeners, do you have a Patriot on your Christmas list that's nearly impossible to shop for? How would you like the ability to get top-of-the-line, hard-to-find gifts at equally hard-to-beat prices without leaving the comfort of your home? Why fight the crowd? Simply log on to your computer for great gifts and deals for the off-the-grid enthusiast in your family. At offthegridchristmas.com, you'll find great prices on the most popular off-the-grid gifts available today. At offthegridchristmas.com, you'll find unbeatable deals on emergency backup power, herb and vegetable seeds, dehydrated foods, emergency evacuation packs, solar ovens, gun safes, and a host of truly unique stocking stuffers. In these hard times, why not give a gift that really counts? A gift that could truly make a difference. Go to offthegridchristmas.com and our Christmas video highlighting perfect gifts for the off-the-grid fans in your family. Unbeatable gear, unbeatable prices, no more searching. Offthegridchristmas.com. That's offthegridchristmas.com.
Racks of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Well, we're talking to Dr. Steve Pachinik. And, of course, you can go to his website. It's got incredible information, stevepachinik.com. Pachinik spelled P-I-E-C-Z-E-N-I-K. Or just try to spell it right and Google will get it for you, stevepachinik.com. Our websites, of course, are prisonplanet.tv, prisonplanet.com, and infowars.com. So you disagree, then, with Gould saying that he thinks this is unifying the country, or perhaps Gould saying that to try to put a good face on it. But I do see your point. If they do try to cause a civil war, they're not going to be able to shift some new government in and control that. It's going to break the country up. But some would say that that's what Israel, that's what India might be wanting. So I understand from your perspective, there seems to be no method to this madness. Finishing up on Pakistan, a brief comment on Russia, the attacks now on Hillary, the warships, Russian and U.S. in the Med. The Chinese president saying prepare for war with the U.S. I mean, they haven't talked like that, as you know, in decades. What is this escalation globally all about, Dr. Pachinik?
It's very simple. What they see is a weakness in the president of the United States. When Russia sees a weakness in a president like Obama, who cannot assert his will or is not strong, they start to attack the president. I have to give credit to Hillary for standing up and saying to Putin that, in effect, you are crooked. Furthermore, first of all, you have to know who Putin is. Putin worked in the Stasi under Marcus Wolf for 8 years. He was trained by East German intelligence. In effect, I will tell you something that will be shocking to most people. We in the intelligence community put Putin back in there in order to stabilize Russia after we took down the Soviet Union. The reason we did that is Yeltsin was totally corrupt. It was dismantling the entire republic. And ironically, in the game of stability and national interest, Putin is really, let's say, the output sourcing of CIA and intelligence work at a time when we really were effective in doing what we need. So Putin has hit the good grades of the U.S. government. In turn, he's told to cool it because he knows he's becoming increasingly wealthy by supplying gas and oil to Germany. He himself has been able to play games with China, but in effect, Hillary has done an excellent job of saying, don't push us too far because we can come back and hurt you the way we did under the Soviet Union. Now, the one thing I will ask Hillary to do is not to delist the MEK, which her husband, that group, the Mujahideen, the People's Liberation Army out of Iran, was the terrorist group that her husband put on the list as terrorist. Bush Jr. put on the list as terrorist. So that's excellent. China, in turn, is having an economic problem. They're not exporting as much as they can. They have to pay more money for their middle class, and they're having over 75,000 riots a year, which they should have. And actually, the Chinese middle class and students are being thrown out because there's not enough work for them. And I would say to my Chinese compatriots there to continue to fight the Chinese government, the Communist Party, is encroaching, as the New York Times showed very well, into private entrepreneurs. So what's happening is, in order to distract the attention away from China, they're trying to project their force structure into East Asia. And we hasn't turned correctly, are moving our naval bases. The SAFEPAC, that's Command and Chief of the Pacific, we're moving all our naval assets into the Straits of Malacca, the China Sea, in order to deny access to the Chinese transport systems so that if they get out of control, because there's an area called the Spratly Islands where there's a lot of oil, and China has illegally claimed the oil belongs to them. So they are now in a small conflict with Vietnam, Cambodia, the Philippines, and Indonesia. We, in turn, and I think it's a very good strategy Hillary's done, is made Vietnam our ally, Indonesia our ally, Myanmar, which was suppressed, our ally, and Cambodia, which I worked on the Khmer Rouge and the disarming. So from that point of view, what's happening is we are effectively moving our strategic interests to the Far East in order to contain and deny access to the Chinese. In terms of Europe, we have a real problem, but not as much of a problem as everybody believes. Our exports to Germany, France, and Italy are not as great as everybody thinks. What is a problem is, again, the issue of the core signs of the world. He is totally corrupt. Now, I say this not as a psychiatrist, as a man who changed regimes, but I was also a managing director of a major investment banking firm, which I took down in 6 months because of their own corruption. That was Kidder Peabody. So I know exactly what Corzine did. He did off-balance sheet accounting, which means that what the Senate is looking at is on the PL, profit and loss statements and the balance sheet, the official. What he did was unofficially take all the monies from our farmers, our hardworking farmers and American citizens, use that $600 million to invest in high-risk 37-to-1 ratio risk. In other words, if I put in a dollar, I'm betting on $37 that I can make money on it. And he risked it on sovereign debt on an off-balance sheet accounting. That means if you and I did that, you and I would be in prison. Corzine must go to prison. There is no ifs, ands, and buts about it. I speak as a former managing director, as a former gunslinger in the private industry, and you know very well, and as a former individual who brought in the head of the SEC to clean out a guy named Gary Lynch. Corzine must go to prison. If he does not go to prison, it will be an indication to our farmers, to our citizens, that the system is so corrupt that not even the most corrupt of all of them will be exonerated. So we have a problem here. And if our judicial system can't handle it, our legislative system can't handle it, then the people of the United States, the farmers and the American people must handle it personally, because he's corrupt.
All right, Doc, we're out of time. Hopefully we can get you back up next week for an update.
I'll come on next week. I like it. Thank you very much, Alex, and thank your audience.
All right, thank you for coming on with us. If Corzine can get away with leveraging $600 million to now $3 billion missing and say, I don't know where the money went, I mean, that's ridiculous. He was the CEO. And for the first time in the mercantile's history, just say, the money's gone, you're not getting it, most of you. And people's private accounts of companies they bought, and then they looted the accounts. Just amazing. If they can get away with that, the sky's the limit. Now, we have seen a giant homeland security movement in this nation to demonize patriots, people that prepare, people that homeschool. It's already done. The die's already cast. I mean, the Justice Department has now been caught, and it's been confirmed, in perjury, shipping guns themselves to Mexico, not just selling them out of gun shops, to destabilize Mexico, to take control of other drug cartels, and to then blame the Second Amendment. That's CBS News, New York Times. They are criminals. So the sky is the limit. And I've told you this for years. The banker bailouts, what's happening in Europe, they're going to implode the world economy to bring in the world government. You've heard Lindsey Williams. You've heard Gerald Celente, Max Kaiser. You've heard Steve Pachinik. They all agree. Dr. Paul Craig Roberts, Bob Chapman, Ron Paul. Collapse. Collapse by design. And so I get up here. Many revolutionaries finance the revolution by robbing banks or by robbing stagecoaches in the old days. The founding fathers did that, you know, by taking British ships. We don't do that. We use the free market system promoting things I believe in to fund the nightly news, the daily radio show / TV, the award-winning films that reach tens of millions apiece, the websites that reach millions a day now, with the truth. We don't do like the communist and others, you know, in modern times out robbing people to fund themselves. I promote things I believe in. And now everybody's getting into the food business. It is hysterical. I listened to San Antonio radio. I listened to two radio stations this morning. San Antonio AM, in between listening to voice messages. And then I tuned to 93.7 KLBJ and heard an ad for a storable food company saying, don't end up at the FEMA camp. Basically, you know, never stand on a bread line if you own your own bread, taking everything that, you know, Steve Shanks basically put out over the years and saying it. I mean, that means it's at all-time proportions when everywhere I tune and on TV I see storable food. The funny thing is, we're not going to be mean and say the companies. Most of these companies you see out there are either selling old food or foreign food that's still somewhat old, or they're trying to get Steve Shank, who's got the biggest factories, the biggest outfits in the country, to have him produce for him. And he's so busy, he's like, no, I'm not doing it. And a lot of people claim they're the oldest or they're the best. No, Steve Shank is. I've looked into it. And he's where I've gotten my storable food. I bought it other places and it had MSG or weird stuff or was made in China. Just incredible. I get my storable foods from eFoodsDirect.com. Now, I didn't get him on today. I got him on to be an informational expert for us because of what's happening in the country. And then I automatically turn it into a food pitch because with my sponsors, I believe in them. I promote what I do. Gold, silver, food, guns, pro-family. I mean, I homeschooling, I do it. You know, whatever you hear me promote, I do it. Except for one area, because some things we can't buy that aren't made in Mexico or somewhere else. Most of our products are made in America. Some aren't. Or part of it isn't. You know, the glue for the DVDs is made in China. Sorry, they don't make it anywhere else. You know, I mean, stuff like, yeah, they're made in the U.S., but part of it's from China. The point is, I walk the walk, I talk the talk, and then when I talk the talk, I walk the walk. So I got Steve on. We'll have him this segment, the next, and then into eight after. So part of a segment, then two others, because I got him on a little bit late here. I called him and said, please come on, because, you know, we're getting calls from people saying that they're calling you and all this stuff because of two different news articles I've got here in front of me. Here is News Channel 5.com, the big one of the big TV stations there in Tennessee, in Nashville. And it says that for emergencies, they're doing door-to-door assessment for disaster preparedness. And our contacts in Tennessee have confirmed, they won't say what the 22 questions are, but it's, do you own firearms? Do you have storable food? The news says they ask 22 questions, but then don't tell you the 22 questions. So we know. So we have this article. Then Stuart Rhodes is confirmed. He knows the name of the place. They don't want to be public. It's a small Mormon cannery, you know, where they, you know, sell storable foods. People can bring their own farmers and get it stored because they believe not just in selling you food. They want to teach you how to do it, which everybody used to do. My grandparents on my dad's side, you know, candle the day they died. And I guess that's weird and evil, but that's what, you know, the grasshoppers don't store food. The ant does, and the ant survives. But continuing here, you know, any frontier stock are into storing food. It's just, it's fun to do. It's good to can your own food, and you do it. But their Tennessee chapter head, Rand Cardwell, went to it, confirmed. They went to this Mormon cannery. The feds came in, FEMA, and wanted to know their list of who was buying food. And they said, A, we don't keep list, and B, we're not going to give it to you. You know, you don't have a warrant. Get out of here. But this story's gone huge. It's just absolutely gone huge. And so people have been calling us. They've been calling eFood saying, well, have the feds come to you? No. No, no, no. Read the article. It's not eFoods Direct. It's a small outfit. So we don't know if there's some group they sold to that the government's concerned about, but why would you be concerned about, you know, dried peas or whatever? But I believe because of Tennessee and the checkpoints and everything, it's a testing site with the roadside checkpoints, the TSA, all of it is centering around Tennessee and the states that are around it. That's the center of the country, the heartland of the nation, you know, the volunteer state. And you know, Tennessee was basically founded Texas. Most of my ancestors were from Alabama and Tennessee. The point is that, you know, talk about Texas, you know, rootin' tootin', fighting for freedom. That's all out of Tennessee. So the system does not like Tennessee, period. And there's definitely stuff going on there, but we don't know exactly what's happening yet. But you add this into other stuff that's gone on, and executive orders about, you know, food hoarding. So with one arm, the government says, get ready, store food. And then with the other, though, then it's like, ooh, I had the Austin police chief here a couple days ago in studio, and after he's like, why are you into storing food, Alex? And I'm like, well, the government stores stuff, food and weapons. So, and the cops all that were with him thought it was, you know, well, I guess they were laughing at him or me. They claimed they were listeners. But the point is, you're crazy with all this coming down on you to count on the government to have storable food for you. So I'm a long 5-6 minute preface. We'll keep them as long as we have to get this covered and then go to Bob Chapman. But Steve Schenck, you are the national expert. That's why I've got you here. You've been in this 40 years. You are the big outfit. You are the quality food. You are the real McCoy. You're not all these other people rushing in now that folks are finally concerned and getting food. You were country when country wasn't cool. You were canning food and when it wasn't cool because it's, you know, part of your common sense belief system. So you are the preeminent expert on this. That's why we've got you here. But I'm still going to turn into a pitch for food because I don't care. People need to get it. I know you said, I'm not coming on to pitch food. And I said, I want you on to be our expert. So you're here. Tell us what's going on.
Awesome.
We've got Steve Schenck joining us for the first time ever from video Skype. Steve, are you there?
I am, Alex. It's nice to hear your voice again.
It's good to have you. Now, we're going to break in a few minutes. You know I'm long-winded, but break down your view at a preliminary level on this this information from Tennessee.
Well, I think it's really interesting that one of the things that we've always done, Alex, is we've concluded that everything has an advantage for us if we look at it the right way. When the Patriot Act was passed and it was indicated that if you had a disaster and you weren't capable of sustaining yourself for 30 days, that you'd be required to go to a gathering center. This was quite offensive in some perspectives, but if you think about it, if in fact the relief organizations were going to try to support the people who hadn't properly taken care of themselves, they'd have a really hard time delivering breakfast, lunch, and dinner to 5 million homes at any given point in time. Cannot be done. That's the strongest argument for families actually taking responsibility for themselves. So what we've always said, and you and I've had many conversations on this subject, is that those who are capable of preparing and taking care of themselves must do it. It's not only their personal responsibility to their families, but it's their patriotic duty as Americans to take care of themselves so that the relief organizations who are willing and prepared to take care of families can be free to take care of those who are unable or unwilling to take care of themselves when the disasters come. So, much more a common sense perspective. Let me address immediately the subject of the Tennessee issue. As I understand it, some agents went in and were asking one of the LDS cannery operations for their records. And appropriately, the response was, no, we don't keep records of things like that. It's not something that we do. And in our case, we're a large nationwide organization. We're shipping food all over the country, and we're into other countries, in fact. And so food is a very private and personal thing. If you walked up to your friend and said, how much money do you have in your savings account? They'd consider it kind of offensive. Some people in the climate that we have, if you walked up to them and said, how many guns do you have? They'd consider it somewhat offensive. And that would be private personal information. How much gold do you have? That type of thing is what the German government's tried to get the kids to tell their parents by giving them candy during World War II. But the fact is that, very simply, food is so personal. It's the greatest dependency that we have. And the wisdom of preparing yourself and storing and having the ability to control that. You see, people can't control the disasters that occur, the man-made events that are referred to in some of the FEMA council to get prepared. People can't control any of that, but they can control their greatest dependency by having a supply of food. So having said that, very simply our perspective on the records that we have of people that use their credit cards and pay cash and do whatever they do to get themselves in a situation where they have reliable security for their family. All of those records are encrypted, kept off site, and very, very secure. And we don't see that as necessary because of the federal government being hostile. We see that as just an extremely important issue of privacy. You can't go into a bank and say to the manager of the bank, hey, listen, I know John Schmelz, and I want to know how much money is in his account. That's a personal thing. And your food being even more basic than money, being even more basic than ammunition and guns, being even more basic than just about anything else, for families that are concerned about taking responsibility and fulfilling their patriotic duty to be responsible Americans and take care of themselves, that's a very private matter, and it's just as secure and just as importantly done so as would be your bank account or anything else that you have.
Well, Steve, very, very I mean, what does this tell us, though? Because we know that police departments, state departments, they've been hoarding food for years now. The fact that they are wanting to know this, why do you think they're going door to door in Tennessee? Why are they focusing on Tennessee? Is Tennessee a beta test? I mean, what's your gut on that?
Well, my gut is that yes, it can possibly be.
Hey, I love that ringer. That's awesome. Go ahead and start over.
My gut feel on the Tennessee issue is that there are elements within the federal organization that are interested in tracking and finding out what's going on with the folks. You can look at it from a positive standpoint and say, well, gee whiz, now I know that some of the work in Tennessee is being done by just saying, hey, we want to make sure people are listening to us and preparing, and we want to take a survey to see how many people are doing it so we can encourage it more. Unfortunately, from our past history, that has not been the motivation in many cases for gathering information on the part of the system. So I think that it would be well taken by families to be concerned with this. I would think that it would cause people, if there is that much interest and it is somewhat negative from the standpoint of our personal freedoms, I would think that the wise thing for families to do is to take this as a maybe a red flag that says, hey guys, if it's that much of a concern and it could be a negative issue, it might be something that people need to consider really getting serious about getting themselves prepared.
Well, that's my next point, is that government has always made fun of being prepared because they want you dependent. Unless you're in Switzerland where they've got their head screwed on straight. They say, have a year of food, have firearms, know how to use them. That's because Switzerland wants to be sovereign and secure. And then expanding on that, now the feds, as you know, the last few years do have billboards up. They are saying have some storable food. But I think that's just so when things collapse, they can say, oh, see, we warned you, knowing most people really aren't getting prepared. But, I mean, look at all the stuff that's happening. Everything we talked about years ago is coming true. It's just, this is real insurance. You can't believe in paper insurance. You can't believe in a paper dollar the way this world's going. You've got to believe in friends and family, your relationship with God, and then physically food, water, firearms, and property. And look, I've moved to the country. I've got a well. I'm putting in the solar. I got a garden. I mean, I know what's coming, the second Great Depression. But then there's the issue. My wife says, well, what do we do? We're here in the country. People know we've got food. The government could come do something. And I'm like, listen, they're criminals. I'm not going to be in the worst position of having nothing and then, well, nobody will want me because I have nothing. I've got to be ready. Just because, and of course, the answer is then have some of it hidden offsite. Don't put all your eggs in one basket. That's what I've done. I've got my stuff spread out so much. Good luck. And then, well, what if the government demands it? These are criminals. They can't take all our food. They can't take all our guns. Some people say, well, I'm not going to buy a gun. They might confiscate it. because they might want to confiscate it is why you need it. It shows how important a gun and food is when you go into a situation like this. It'd be like, well, the government of this steamship is trying to confiscate anybody that has life rafts in their rooms. And it's like, well, since you want it, I'm not going to hide my life raft, you know, that's in the closet that isn't blown up. So since you're asking for it, here, go ahead and have it. It's your life raft. It's not theirs. And so you don't not have a life raft because the government might try to come take it. Do you see my point? It's like people saying, I don't want to have kids. The world's just too bad. Well, we wouldn't be here if our ancestors had that same attitude. Who went through a lot more than we're going through physically, I will assure you. You know, it's like, I don't want to have kids. They could die in a car wreck. I mean, it's this total give up on society attitude. I know you've heard it before. Well, I don't want storable food because the government will find out. If the government's that criminal, you better well have some storable food. Do you see my point, Steve? I know I'm ranting.
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, what we try and do, we know that a lot of people look at people like us, folks like us, and say, boy, they're half a bubble off with one oar in the water, a brick shy of a load and a taco short of a blue plate special because they're into this right-wing radical stuff. This all that this news article and these events in Tennessee are showing us is that we become more and more responsible for our own freedoms. Food is freedom, my friends. And however you want to look at this, it is alarming that they came and asked. But the answer that they got was, we keep no records. And besides, if we did keep records, they're none of your business. Well, that's why eFoods from the very beginning has been very, very careful.
Steve, stay there. Finish up on the other side and then talk about ways to protect your food and how long it lasts. Then Bob Chapman's coming up with a blitz of news. But eFoodsDirect.com/Alex, they have their Christmas and holiday specials right there. eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNLive.com today.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions. Yet many are unaware of the entire function of the silver lung system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs Generator. Not only does the silver lung system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lung System at www.silverlungs.com to learn more about how the Silver Lung System works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, we've got an insane news blitz coming up in T-minus 8 minutes when Bob Chapman joins us. You're going to want to stay with us. I'm going to run down just crazy news breaking left and right, get his quick take on it, get some economic breakdown, and then take your calls. But I wanted to get Steve Schenck on because our phones were exploding, asking, you know, what's happening in Tennessee. And then, of course, obviously being the biggest storable foods and most reliable in the country, eFoodsDirect.com. The J. Michael Stevens Group, they got just massive phone calls about it. It's just unbelievable to see how crazy things are getting. But, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't have firearms and you don't know how to use them, you're crazy. And if you don't, get basic training for them and store them right, you're crazy as well. And I'm not trying to lecture you here, but this is all common sense. The system wants us domesticated. And in every case, from Stalin to Pol Pot right through, they use food as a weapon. Henry Kissinger said they'd use food as a weapon. In State Department Memorandum 200, The UN said it in 96 at their World Food Conference. That's why they're trying to shut down family farms and ranches. But look, America's fighting back. Here's The Hill today. I meant to get to this earlier with Steve. Farm dust bill approved in the House. The legislation is needed, H.R. 1633, because any dust, including hay, is considered a toxic waste, $10,000 fines. It passed 268 to 150. Now, that's the EPA shutting down most of our power plants now that aren't General Electric owned. This is a military economic attack on us by the bankers. They don't like the wealth of this country. They want to consolidate it. They want you under their control. Defeat them. Grow gardens. So what if the cops come and say you can't and they have to inspect it in areas of Oklahoma and Michigan? They're crazy authoritarians and they need to be confronted. And somebody wants to know about your food, they can go to Hades. And at a certain point, ladies and gentlemen, look, I got guns and I got food and you're not getting them. At a certain point, you got to say, I'm manned up and that's the end of it. Now go ahead and try it. You just can't live your whole life groveling. It invites these wolves. Now, side issue, I'm ranting, and I've got to get you back up soon for a full hour, Steve, to talk everything food, because I'm hearing food ads everywhere, all these fly-by-night companies I've never heard of. It's obviously people are finally waking up. I hope they go to efoodsdirect.com/Alex for those specials. I hope they give you guys a call, but you're not here for that today. And I said we wouldn't go there, but I can't help it. I believe in this, so I can't shut up. But briefly, in we're even out of time. I got Bob Chapman holding. He's great. He's awesome. He's a sweetheart. I'll get his take after you leave. Stay there. We'll do two more minutes on the other side, but get started now. What do you recommend you do? Because I know you've given advice for years on the food. If things do break down, it's not the government you're going to have to worry about, probably. It's going to be thieves looking for it. What do you do with the food?
Well, very simply, you should try and keep it in a secured area. In terms of temperature and storage, that type of thing, keep your food as comfortable as you are. But be very careful. Treat it like it is your wealth. It is your life. So don't be talking about it a great deal. Encourage your friends and family to store their own. But the best attitude that I can give you is that food is your greatest dependency and the way that you maintain your freedom. Food is freedom right now. So what you have to do is look at it from the standpoint, if you don't want to take a totally negative attitude toward the government and the possible confiscation and things, if you just want to be reasonable and say, look, it's my personal responsibility to care for those I love. It's also, as an American, my patriotic responsibility to take care of my family so that the...
I'll tell you what, stay there, stay there. Stay there and finish your statement, then we'll go right to Bob Chapman. Bob holding there at theinternationalforecaster.com. Folks can give eFoods Direct a call and ask any questions, get brochures, 800-876-0871, 800-876-0871, or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Now is the time to get ready.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. This holiday season, more than half of our nation is in need of help due to the shattered economy. So now is the time to express the holiday spirit more than ever. Consider helping those you love with the most important gift, a supply of delicious, easy to fix, and very storable foods from efoodsdirect.com. Their holiday gift and family pack start at $99 for a 16-day supply. While their 5-week supply of quick and easy to fix meals includes a personal backpack in case of a grab and go emergency. Order their combo gift pack and you'll save hundreds, plus get free shipping on your entire order. Call eFoods today at 800-409-5633 or visit them online at efoodsdirect.com/Alex to find the special. That's 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond.
turn jeans inside out. Diamond Gusset Jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond Gusset Jeans got it. Others don't.
Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide. This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Okay, it's the Friday edition, and we've been so jam-packed with news and guests, I haven't taken calls. But I've gotten better lately getting to some calls some days, because I want to take them. But we will next week, absolutely. Jaron, I know we've got a lot of big guests, and now Ron Paul says he's coming on Tuesday. But we're going to not get too many guests next week, at least an hour or two a day, because I want to hear from you while all this is happening, because I do hear from you in the comments, the emails, and everything else that's happening. There is so much crazy news here that we're going to get to. It's all just off the charts that we're going to be breaking down, and we're going to get Bob Chapman's take on it. And you know what? Take some financial questions for Bob Chapman. Specific questions for Bob Chapman, 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. But going back to Steve Shank, and again, I had the idea to get him on today because we were getting calls, they were getting calls, because the feds have gotten GPS everybody's doors. They've got executive orders about food confiscation, shutdown of media in an emergency. But now they're testing the takeover of the media for the first time ever last month. The 9th of November. They are now manning the FEMA camps. And we got the FEMA documents. You can call Kellogg, Brown, and Root. And they're now getting companies set up to within 72 hours notice, when they pull the trigger, man camps all over the U.S. for civil emergencies, environmental, whatever. The Pentagon's hiring internment specialists. They're training everybody for urban warfare and riot control. Look at what's happening in Europe. And people, even as this is happening, can't believe it's happening. By admitting it's happening and saying it's wrong, people will be aware of it and say no, and know it's staged as the next phase happens. Look, I went to urban warfare drills 13, 14 years ago and knew this was coming. And I knew it'd take them a while. This is a long-term strategic takeover. The globalists have the country, but they really want to transform it. And when I witnessed military training to confiscate our guns, round up citizens, search our houses, and since then, now it's admitted. I told you 9 years ago TSA would be on the highways. I watched a TSA meeting on C-SPAN for 2 hours. So, I mean, I know what they're going to do because they've told us. I knew they'd bankrupt Europe and announce a bank of the world. Then they'll bankrupt the U.S., merge us all in. You'll pay three taxes at least directly to the criminals. They now admit in Time Magazine, Newsweek, it is Bank of the World, Goldman Sachs at the head of it, taking over Europe, getting rid of their sovereignty. That's some of the news. The Prime Minister of England has vetoed it. For the first time ever, England has used its veto to not enter this, because that would be the end of England's sovereignty. So wild stuff's going to start happening. Reportedly, they wouldn't even shake Cameron's hand. There was a big argument where Sarkozy and Merkel, in fact, I had those articles like 10 minutes ago. They're here in my stack. I'll get to them. The news is coming in so fast, I can't even deal with it right now. Finishing up with our food expert. He's also our sponsor, but I want to get him on just to break down what he's seeing. I'm seeing total media saturation now, which means obviously people are finally taking action. I know you've had to add more factories, massively increase your year-out buying of food for crops that aren't even planted yet to keep prices down at eFoodsDirect.com. But Steve, just briefly, is this the greatest food buying you've ever seen?
Oh, it's absolutely absurd. I have never, and the thing is that what we're doing as Americans is we're competing with other countries. China and India, the big population countries of the world, are out there farming the planet. And what folks don't realize is that we literally are in a battle for our food. And what has to happen is realize that events like in Tennessee are just an indicator of how important food is. If it's drawing that kind of attention, some of it negative in this case, the fact is that we as Americans, you as a family, have to look at the fact that you are competing for your food today. The reason food prices are going up so much is these other countries are coming in and buying the raw materials that we're out there fighting to get so that we can process the food and get it to families so that they can put it into their storage. And in fact, a lot of those families are eating the food right now because the food costs in the grocery store are so high. So this is right now, you might say it's a war for freedom, but we are in a worldwide food war right now. So get yours is the only thing I can say.
And by the way, you saw this, Steve, 5 years ago saying, watch, it's the commodities are going to go up. And now you watch any financial show, they admit the elite are getting out of paper currencies and going into farmland and food production. And they're saying that's the next big bubble.
And Alex, so, mm-hmm. Alex, they are dumping their gold to go into food. They're dumping gold now. Remember when we said that it was paper going to gold and then eventually the only currency on the planet would be food? That's where we are. People, large investors are dumping gold to get into food. They're buying the agriculture. What we're doing and what I've concentrated all my time on right now is buying raw materials out ahead of time so that these other countries don't buy them away from us so Americans can have food. That's where we are. And this Tennessee thing should only light the fuse that says this thing is in the process of exploding right now. You are absolutely right. You've been right the way you've been calling it for the last 10 years, Alex.
Well, I wish I wasn't right. We're watching the New World Order come into being. Steve Schenck, I guess I should give it out here. In fact, I've got it here in my stack. I want to give out the phone number. It's 800-876-0871, 800-876-0871, or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex to find the holiday specials. You've got some free sample packs and a lot more. Folks just pay for shipping and a lot of other specials running at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Steve Schenck, thanks for joining us.
Alex, I appreciate you.
We appreciate you. Thanks for coming on to explain to everybody what's happening out there. Okay, for the rest of the hour, Bob Chapman every Friday joins us. Always gracious to do that. Former military intelligence, the largest private silver and gold broker for a very long time, had the largest private newsletter, put out the Gary Allen Report for years, helped publish None Dare Call It Conspiracy. Gary Allen's son now runs Politico. Wow, talk about the son being different from the dad. All of that is going on. And look, I've got insane news here in front of me, but in the 5 minutes we've got before we go to break, it's quite frankly, I'm looking for my Cameron articles. I've got a bunch of mainstream articles where they're saying Cameron says no to the New World Order and stuff. I'm going to dig those out coming up to get Bob's take on it. But Bob, I know you always are on top of it. I haven't asked you if you saw it yet, but it just came out 2 hours ago. Do you know about Cameron vetoing this super EU, stripping all the countries of their sovereignty because they realize England would forfeit all its sovereignty to the euro? I mean, he's a globalist, and he said he was going to support it. But what does this veto mean? And then you wrote an article, and others have written it, mainstream articles, admitting this is a total destruction of sovereignty. How are things going in Europe, where you lived for many years and studied things? What's happening right now? How big is this?
I think that England and the U.S. for a long time have wanted to take the euro down. As we all know, England never belonged to the euro, but they did and do belong to the European Union. And it looks like they made the excuse, look, we want concessions. And Sarkozy from France and Merkel from Germany said, no, we're not going to do that. And he says, good, I'm not joining your group. You're not going to do that to my country. The group is what they want to do, and this will eventually affect England, but not immediately, because this ESM, European Stabilization Mechanism, only would apply to the 17 countries that are in the Eurozone. The other 10 that don't use the euro, they'd get it later, and that includes England. So England's just saying, look, we're not going to do that. We're not going to allow you to have a committee in Luxembourg and not going to allow you to have 17 or 27 secretaries of the treasuries is what they'll call them, so you'll understand what they are, finance ministers. We're not going to give them immunity to do what they want to do, to tell governments what they can spend and how they can spend it within their own confines of their own country. And they want to control the budgetary and fiscal policies of each of the 17 countries originally, and then later the other 10. And ostensibly you'd have a new world currency, the euro, which the other 10 wouldn't even be part of anyway. So England's saying, look, we're not going to do that. It's surprising. But then again, really, is it? You know, they've been ambivalent about joining the euro for years. They stayed out of it. Denmark, Sweden stayed out. And they've come back for votes since, and they've stayed out. They voted to stay out. And so what's going on here is a power struggle. And quite frankly, I think it plays right into Germany's hands, because 65% of Germans never wanted to be in the euro. The same number, if not 70%, depending upon whether you count men or women, women are higher, they're 70%. They did not want the European Union. And Germany was forced into it. They said, look, they, being America and England and France, and particularly America and France, if you want to reamalgamate Germany, bring your country together, then you've got to stand up and be in the euro and the European Union. So Helmut Kohl gave in, and that's what they did. It cost the Western Germans, we'll call them, gazillions of trillions of dollars.
Oh, yeah. For those that don't know, Germany is still basically occupied. But back when they, you know, started merging the two countries, it was occupied, you know, from the east and from the west. And Germany didn't even really have a say, from my research. I mean, wasn't even Helmut Kohl still a quasi-puppet? I mean, it was only de Gaulle. The French had to kick England and the U.S. out. Remember what de Gaulle did? And he grabbed his own nukes back and all that?
That's right.
You remember all that? Was a big stand down right there.
De Gaulle was for France, and that was the end of it. He didn't care about any other alliance.
Well, yeah, he was ready to order the military to get into a fight. All right, because the bankers don't take your country over. It's like, oh, well, Hitler took over. Well, we'll take it. And then France had to say, no, get out of here. America has to do the same thing to the New World Order.
The perfect water for drinking, bathing, and cleaning. Right at your fingertips? Yes, you can now have the most powerful water ionizer on the market for less than half the price of competitors. The Genesis Platinum Water Ionizer from GibsonsHealth.com creates the perfect drinking water of 9.5 pH, automatically cleans every time you use it, and even tells you when to change filters. Other 7-plate water ionizers are priced at $2,000 or even $3,000. But the Genesis Platinum is only $16.95. Get yours today at GibsonsHealth.com. Under Nutritionals, be sure to click on Essential Oils for aromatic liquids extracted from a broad range of flowers, stems, seeds, and bark. And to really balance your body, click on Go Green, the most complete green drink available, necessary for survival. All this and more are found at GibsonsHealth.com. Call 800-388-6844. That's 800-388-6844 or GibsonsHealth.com. Healthful living since 1974.
When the food collapse happens, if trucks stop delivering food to supermarket shelves tomorrow, what will you do? How well is your family prepared for a food crisis? How long will you survive? Getting a biodome which produces food for you and your family year-round, even in the dead of winter, is easy, cheap, and extremely liberating. Find out how in an all-new webinar at DomeRevolution.com. Biodome expert Casper Postavsky shows you the three actions you must start taking right now to start preparing your family for food shortages and survive the economic collapse. How to quickly and easily build your own geodesic biodome. DomeRevolution.com. You'll find out how to use aquaponics to literally have an automated food supply which grows you food year-round, how to grow extremely nutrient-dense food, and use the secrets of biodynamics to restore completely dead soil. Get prepared. Watch the Biodome webinar. Go to DomeRevolution.com and sign up now.
Burglars love easy targets, like a dark house that looks like no one is home. Don't let your home be the next target. Make it look like someone is home watching television with fake TV. Fake TV is a small electronic device that makes the same light as a real television, so from outside it looks like someone is home watching TV. Fake TV plugs in just like a lamp on a timer, but is far more convincing to burglars. Fake TV deters burglars, costs far less than an alarm, comes with AC adapter, and is highly recommended by numerous police departments. Use it anytime you're away from home. To order your fake TV for only $34.95, go to faketv.com or call 1-877-5-FAKE-TV. Each additional fake TV is only $29.95. So get one for you and give one or more for Christmas. Now through Christmas, get free standard shipping on any quantity fake TV purchase. Call 877-5-FAKE-TV or go to faketv.com. Faketv.com, the burglar deterrent.
Introducing a diabetes breakthrough, an easy, natural, organic way to bring relief to diabetics. Introducing MDS Forte, a concentrated super strength extract formulated for those who are looking for relief. What can MDS Forte do for you? MDS Forte reduces glucose levels safely and effectively, reduces cholesterol and triglyceride levels, increases HDL or good cholesterol while reducing LDL or bad cholesterol. MDS Forte reduces A1C, improves eyesight and circulation to the limbs, and helps with weight loss. Is non-toxic, caffeine-free, 100% natural, 100% organic, and comes with a 100% money-back guarantee. Waiting for the side effects disclaimers? With MDS Forte, there are none. Order a 25-day treatment of MDS Forte by calling 213-405-5355, 213-405-5355, or visit bestbloodsupport.com. That's bestbloodsupport.com for MDS Forte, a diabetes breakthrough.
Yeah, what do you need the bankers to do? Wear big devilish top hats? And that's all John Corzine needs. I haven't even gotten Bob Chapman's take on that yet. We will be taking your calls, 800-259-9231, your financial questions for him. And I will, at the next segment, get into a ton of stuff. And yes, I'm wearing a top hat, folks. I was in a shop in Arkansas, and they were selling hats, and they had a top hat, and I thought I'd buy one because John Corzine is going to be on the nightly news tonight. It's not going to really be John Corzine, but I'm going to do a little bit. I occasionally do a little comedy bit. And so look for that tonight, 7 o'clock, InfoWars Nightly News. All right, going back to Bob Chapman, finishing up with the Euro, I then want to get into the incredible MF Global testimony where he just said, I don't know where the money is. Gee, I'm really upset. I don't know where it is. The money disappeared, and then I resigned the next day, and the head of the CFTC that worked for me for many years at Goldman Sachs, he's invested, he's disappeared, and the Congress is basically like, well, that's all right, the money's missing, and it's first time in 150 years at the Chicago Mercantile, now the CME Group, that this has happened, but we're just not going to worry about it. So a new precedent is set. Bob Chapman, please continue.
Well, the precedent is set in the Corzine affair, we'll call it, MF Global. They're in commodities. Commodities are different than the other two major markets, which are bonds and shares. In fact, the bond market's 100 times bigger than the share market, and the commodity market makes up about 1% of everything. So it's a very small market. And I've always told people to stay away from it. And the reason why is you got to be a pro to be in there. And the agreement that you sign isn't worth the paper it's written on. They can hypothecate what's in your account. and they were rehypothecating, from what I understand. For those of you who don't know, hypothecation is lending. So if you have an account, and it's a margin account, which you have to have, then they can take the things which are in your account and use them, and sometimes lend things that are in there, money, whatever. And they were not only doing that, they were relending it again, which in the United States is illegal. In Europe, it is legal, and they use that loophole. But the bottom line here under Sarbanes-Oxley is that Mr. Corzine, as the CEO of the company, had to sign off on the contents of the audit, and he had to know that there was money that was being misappropriated. And this didn't happen a month ago when we saw it. It was happening 6, 7, 8 months before. And that means the CFTC had to have known about it. Well, they're saying they didn't. Well, of course they did. And, of course, being Corzine's friend, the man that runs the CFTC, I think he probably looked the other way, like they and the SEC have for so many years with politically connected or financially connected people. And I think he is as guilty as can be. I think his testimony touched upon subjects where it wouldn't subject him to prosecution. If they're going to find a way to prosecute him criminally, they're going to have to do their own digging. And that avoidance is what that appearance was all about. And there'll be more appearances, and he'll do the same thing. What they're all looking for, and there was more than him involved, is fines. And if I was running the CFTC, I'd say, well, that's simple. You 15 guys over there, you did all this stuff. And we're missing $1.2 billion, so come up with the money and pay the people back. And then we'll kick you out of the business so you can't do this again.
But they won't even do that. It's like the big banks caught laundering $376 billion in 2 years. They paid a $110 million fine on it. We did the math on that. It's like, what, 0.03?
Chump change. We saw that with Michael Milken as well. He stole $3 billion, gave the government $1 billion, and lived happily ever after.
Yeah, but that was one-third. It's like I rob a bank, and I've got $5 million, and I give them $100. So the cops pull up, and they go, oh, Mr. Jones, we need the $100. I'm, oh, here you go. Here's $100 of the giant bags of cash I'm stealing. I mean, it's just lunacy.
Well, it shows you how systemically corrupt our system is, and it is really a criminal syndicate.
And it's getting worse, undoubtedly. All right, I want to come back, cover news headlines, and get your quick take on it in a news blitz, Bob. And then I want to get to some phone calls for financial questions for Bob Chapman. Then, of course, we'll be back this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central, with the syndicated radio/TV show. But, hey, I'll be back tonight, 7 o'clock, with Lord Christopher Monckton and more.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Hi, this is Alex Jones. This holiday season, more than half of our nation is in need of help due to the shattered economy. So now is the time to express the holiday spirit more than ever. Consider helping those you love with the most important gift, a supply of delicious, easy-to-fix, and very storable foods from eFoodsDirect.com. Their holiday gift and family packs start at $99 for a 16-day supply, while their 5-week supply of quick and easy-to-fix meals includes a personal backpack in case of a grab-and-go emergency. Order their combo gift pack, and you'll save hundreds, plus get free shipping on your entire order. Call eFoods today at 800-409-5633 or visit them online at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex to find the special. That's 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Hey everybody, Alex Jones here. If you're looking for the perfect Christmas gift, listen up. This will make your holiday shopping very easy. This year, give a seed bank from one of our oldest sponsors, Solutions from Science, to your friends and family. Here's why. The Survival Seed Bank will give any friend or loved one the ability to grow a full acre crisis garden of nutritionally dense, life-sustaining food. And the Survival Seed Bank is not just a box of open-pollinated seeds. It's an indestructible, waterproof seed bank that can even be buried if we face a real meltdown. And here's the best part. All the seeds in the Survival Seed Bank go through strict germination testing, so you can be confident you're not buying old seeds. Give a Survival Seed Bank this Christmas by going to SurvivalSeedBank.com. That's SurvivalSeedBank.com. Or you can call 877-327-0365 to give the gift that produces an ongoing supply of life-sustaining food.
Ladies and gentlemen, your phone calls are coming up here in about 10 minutes for the balance of the hour. If I can get my phone system to uncrash. And the phone calls are there. It's just not displaying them to me. So that's coming up with your questions for Bob Chapman. Let me just read some of the headlines we've already gotten to and then get to some of the new ones. I mentioned these earlier, but I didn't have it in my hand. Daily Mail, we're on our own now. Cameron uses the veto for first time to opt out of new treaty to save the euro and give more power to Brussels. Doesn't save the euro. They always designed it to implode. They admit that, to give them unlimited power. Just incredible power grab happening, economic domination. And they scapegoat Germany like it's running it all. The bureaucrats, the globalists, it's the banks. Germany's fitting the bill. Again, they always spin it off onto some scapegoat. The Germans never had a vote to enter this. The Germans don't want a bailout. They want out of the euro. They don't want to give people money. Continuing, Le Snub, moment Sarkozy dodges Cameron's handshake with a swift body swerve after Prime Minister says no to treaty changes. So here's another one, Merkozy, that's Merkel and Sarkozy combined. Letter to EU, now is the time to strip countries of sovereignty. I mean, they admit they won't even be countries anymore. Unbelievable. Here's another one. UN calls for eco-fascist world government at Durban summit. And we are going to have Lord Christopher Monckton on tonight from South Africa. Bureaucrats in the UN climate summit in Durban have outlined plans for the most draconian, harebrained, and madcap climate change treaty ever produced. And each country and each individual will have their climate debt, of course, paid to the bankers. You can't make this up. And that dovetails with dust from hay, $10,000 fine. Calling tilling the soil a crime against Earth. Here in America, of course, not on other countries. It's the globalists have invested in other countries. They want to shut us down. Oh, my gosh. Continuing here, we've got all of those reports. By the way, that's out of the Hill newspaper. That's not me saying that. You can't make this stuff up. Hey, you can't have a garden in your yard. Hey, you can't sell lemonade. Hey, you can't sell raw milk. The Austin police chief didn't believe me when I said, no, they arrest people for selling raw milk. No, they have year-long stings. He's like, come on, Alex, knock it off. I mean, I don't know how he could be charming and seem smart. the Austin police chief and not know all this stuff's going on? I mean, who are these people in the system that are just so willfully ignorant of everything? Now, he didn't try to weasel out of the whole thing with the Fast and Furious, which is confirmed now to be totally staged in the government memos to be blamed on the Second Amendment. I want to get Bob's take on that. And also, speaking of that, Eric Holder yesterday, we played the clip in the first hour, he says that no one at the DOJ has ever lied. And that even though they said that they weren't over it, it was their intent. Yes, they knowingly lied, but they didn't intend to mislead Congress. More lawyer games. Bob Chapman, what do you make of the Fast and Furious, the latest information on that front? And then what do you make of, in Tennessee, News 5 reports, they are going door-to-door asking about firearms, guns, preparedness. And the article's like, it's no big deal, it's just innocuous, doesn't mention that. We've talked to the folks on the ground. It says there's 22 questions, but they don't, Bob, they don't ask you, you know, about things except your food and firearms and stuff, but the article doesn't even tell people that. Bob, what's your take on just all this craziness?
Well, they're lining everybody up. They'll test it there in Tennessee, and the next thing you know, it'll be all over the country, and everybody will expect it. And they'll come with their questions, and the answer their questions is just that you don't tell them you get food. You don't tell them that you grow food in the backyard. You don't tell them you got any guns. If they ask you, say no.
Well,
you're not under subpoena. You don't have to tell them anything.
Yeah, I don't even answer the door. And when the census person keeps banging, open the door, and I say, look, criminal, I don't care that you're a monkey and got a tag. They're saying you're some federal officer. It's illegal to come here and ask me all these questions. You can ask me how many people live here. Now, are you going to leave if I tell you that? Or are you going to sit there with your fake 50-question garbage? And they say, sir, it is the law. And I go, then call the cops. I slam the door on them. I'm sorry, Bob. Go ahead.
Yeah, but that's okay. I mean, that bears out what I'm saying. Don't tell them. Lie to them. I mean, that's all they do. I mean, let's play their game. And so you don't tell them you've got anything. And as we now know, they're going to bulk food manufacturers and asking, which you did a program on, I guess, yesterday, who's buying all the food. And that's why I told, you know, I started telling people to buy food in 1965. Now, of course, the two batches they bought in between, they've eaten since. But the food was always good. And it's better today the way it's prepared. But like Steve said, it is the most important thing besides water. I mean, you've got to have those two things. And you don't want to let the government or anybody else know what you've got.
Well, I mean, the fact that...
Grandchildren,
yeah.
Don't you tell anything to anybody about anything that you've got.
What do you think of Holder just caught red-handed lying and saying, well, I didn't intend to mislead you. You know, in certified testimony, he was running the whole operation. It's all been confirmed. And he just sits there and says, well, I didn't mean to be misleading when I lied to you. I mean, what an incredible criminal.
Well, that's right. And that's what this has evolved to. There's always been lying. You know, go back to the third century before Christ. You've got the same thing. But it has been refined today into a very fine art. And they all do it. It's a criminal syndicate, and you can expect them from them. You can't expect a level playing field or a fair legal field for you to operate in. You can't count on the courts and the law to defend you. You've got to do what you have to do to survive. And
yeah, some people say, why should I have gold or silver or firearms? They might take it. Well, why not go jump off a cliff now? Because somebody might kill you. The world's always tried to take what you've got. That's why we've had checks and balances to try to protect ourselves. Now they're going out the window. We're all in danger. What do you make of the NDAA passing and the indefinite detention of citizens, military on the street, them doing that now, and the FEMA documents we got where they've got Kellogg, Brown, and Root, who built the camps. That's Wall Street Journal 6 years ago. Now actually preparing to man them. Does that not show us that they're really concerned about collapse?
Yeah, and the outcome of collapse, which is chaos, And, you know, they'll put people in these camps to save them from all the chaos, when in fact it's a suppression technique. But it was to be expected, because America didn't do what it could have done during the 70s and 80s and 90s to stop these people. Nobody wanted to pay attention, and they're still in denial. And they're getting information now from yourself and others all over the world, and there's no excuse for them to be in the position that they're in today. And
yeah, but I've been to a... But I mean, I've been to a picnic, a rodeo, and a World's Fair, and I've never seen, Bob, them actually prepare to activate the camps and to fully staff them. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, that's true. And now they have the reason to do it through this legislation. And, of course, throwing these senators out of office and the congressmen at the House, that's going to help. But it's a little bit late, isn't it? I mean, this shows you the dynamics, the absolute positive reason to have Ron Paul as our next president, and people like him in Congress. If we can accomplish that, we can beat these people. We could turn all this stuff around.
By the way, there's hit pieces out today by the dozen saying Ron Paul, okay, he's probably going to win Iowa, but it's just a fluke, ignore him. He's been in second or third place for the last 6 months. Everybody else falls by the wayside. There are so many skeletons in Gingrich's closet that he'll never be president. He's a ringer. I mean, and they keep trying the mantra, Ron Paul can't win, Ron Paul can't win. God literally always works this way. Here is a great part of the solution, a sign that America wants to go back to the Constitution. Here he is on a silver platter. But you notice he's not, a Ken Doll liar, you know, with a cutesy suit and everything. He's an old man, but he's a statesman and a scholar. Here is our chance. And if America lets these criminals keep us from electing Ron Paul, but see, here's the thing. They know Iowa's a caucus state where it's old-fashioned hands. That's why they know he's going to win. They plan on cheating in the other areas with the machines. But again, they're so scared, Bob, because if he wins in Iowa and then starts winning in landslides, then their machines, it's been proven, get caught if they can only cheat in 5 to 10 point increments. They can't, too big a cheat from the experts I agree with, Bev Harris and others, too big a cheat, they can't do it.
Well, let's put them there. It means the existence of every one of you, children, grandchildren, all your progeny for centuries to come will even live in bondage if you don't elect that man. I can't tell you strongly enough. I've been in this for 53 years, and his life has run parallel to mine. Only he was a doctor and I was a stockbroker. But we're only 2 months apart. That has nothing to do with anything. But anyway.
No, it does. People that you're born at the same time, you're from the same culture, same everything. It's same experiences. It's like broodmates or something. Now, I want to go to Tim, Nancy, John, Kevin, and Phil, and we'll do a little bit of overdrive to finish that with Bob Chapman, but I briefly wanted to do some plugs here. You can get a free year subscription either in hard copy or digital, which is $159 value when you buy one gold franc from Midas Resources. And the gold franc's at a great price, 800-686-2237. If you want to get a complimentary copy, you can just call and they'll send you a hard copy or an email version. It is invaluable reading. Again, you can go to Midas Resources and find that online, or 800-686-2237. And lastly, we're only running this until Christmas. All 18 of my films on DVD are $99.95. That's 70% off. I've never offered anything even near this. I mean, I've never even offered 50% off on the Everything Special. This is 70% off. And you can do all your Christmas shopping at once and support the InfoWar. You know we're fighting hard, folks. You know we're at the tip of the spear here. So, again, you can get all 18 of my films that are on DVD, InfoWars.com, and in the Fed bumper stickers and a citizen rule book. All of that, $99.95. And we're running a special right now, 70% off of that special, 44% off on a yearly membership for the nightly news and the daily video stream of the show and all the films at prisonplanet.tv. And a few months ago, we got a lot of new members, and it would kind of get slow at times and stuff, but we've upgraded everything now. It's super fast, even at peak times. And I appreciate all of you that are PrisonPlanet.tv members. Again, PrisonPlanet.tv, if you need any help or have any questions about signing up. People keep asking about signing up without using a credit card. We've got a deal where you can call us and do that. And I think I'm going to start a deal where you just order it online if you want or call us, and then we just mail you a card with a username and passcode we make up. But you can call us and set it up that way as well, but we're going to develop that system. So 888-253-3139, 888-253-3139. And as long as you get your order into us by the 19th, even by mail, we can guarantee it for Christmas delivery. The P.O. Box is P.O. Box 19549, P.O. Box 19549, Austin, Texas, 78760. All right, let's go to some calls here and then some more news with Bob Chapman. Tim in Washington, you're on the air with your question for Bob.
Yes, I was curious to find out if you guys have a ratio in your head to that's going to trigger a banker collapse or a bank run in America.
Well, there's already bank runs all over Europe centering around Greece because the government's just taking it out through wire transfers, paying it directly to the bankers. Bob Chapman, a metric or numbers to look for are signs of an impending bank run or holiday.
Well, I think the best thing to do in the country that you're in is talk to people who work in banks. And say, you know, do you have a lot of people taking money out? And the teller, if you may, says, do we? I don't know how much it is, but it's a lot. And that's the way you find out. Like we were on a lot, you and I, in Greece over the last couple of years, I've been telling everybody, get your euros out of the bank. And they're doing it. What are they withdrawing? Probably 30% to 40% of the money. And in each country, it's going to continue. It wasn't 2 weeks ago. I told people to get your euros out of the bank in Germany and France and all these other places. Take the money and buy gold and silver, whatever way you can. The best deals you can make for yourself.
And by the way, MF Global is causing people to get their money out of the bank as well. Sorry. Go ahead, Bob.
And if you have gold coins, you can get out of harm's way. I mean, what do you think? For centuries, the British and other armed forces have sewn in British sovereigns into the clothing of airmen and others as well. And they still do it. I don't know what coins they're using right now, but
they use sovereigns. They use
people write to me and tell me.
No, they use quarter ounce British sovereigns. Even their soldiers in the field are issued them. Let's go ahead and talk to John in Ohio. You're on the air with Bob Chapman. Go ahead, John.
A hugely important article by the former Pakistan chief of the Pakistan military completely blows away this phony war on terror. And if you can get it, Alex, it's called ISAF Aggression Against Pakistan. ISAF standing for NATO. And he says those 28 Pakistani soldiers who were killed by the drone a couple weeks ago were not only deliberately murdered, but they were killed because they were attacking Al-Qaeda forces there, and these Al-Qaeda forces sent an SOS to NATO and American aircraft and gunships who rushed to the rescue of these trapped militants. And he says the two Pakistani posts came under intense fire from NATO. The Pakistani officer commanding the post immediately contacted NATO and warned them that they were being attacked.
No, I've seen that in other reports. No, Al-Qaeda works for the globalists. That's on record. But what was the headline on the article you're talking about, John?
ISAF Aggression Against Pakistan. It was an information clearinghouse. I think this shows that even
ISAF Aggression Against Pakistan. We'll look it up. Briefly going to break. But thank you, John. Bob, what's your take on Pakistan?
Oh, they've had American troops airborne special forces guarding that facility for the last 3 or 4 years that I know of. And, you know, one of our subscribers is in that group. And so we know what's going on there. And so I think what they want to do is neutralize Pakistan's nuclear ability by taking it over. And I just don't know how they're going to go about it.
Well, they're going to use civil war. Civil war is the pretext to physically invade. Which, if you think Afghanistan's bad, oh, my gosh. Wow. All right, Bob, stay there. More calls straight ahead. PrisonPlanet.tv.
Discover a natural way to experience cleaner, healthier indoor air without expensive filters and high-priced machines. Discover what healthcare professionals have known for decades. Salt ionizes and purifies indoor air. That's why you need to visit SilverSkyImports.com. SilverSkyImports.com offers a wide assortment of Himalayan crystal salt lamps, handcrafted from salt crystals that are millions of years old, contain healthy ions that eliminate odor, reduce bacteria, and can even help allergy and asthma sufferers, which means you and your family will breathe better, sleep sounder, and have more energy. These salt lamps are available in stunning natural colors and shapes to accent any home or office, are environmentally friendly, and best of all, they're affordable. And don't forget, SilverSkyImports.com also carries gourmet and bath salts. Order today at SilverSkyImports.com or call 800-494-1369. That's 800-494-1369. Breathe easier, feel better, live healthier at SilverSkyImports.com.
Smokers, are you still smoking traditional cigarettes? Are you still smelling up your clothes and car interior, staining your teeth, and getting ashes everywhere? Why? When you could be smoking or vaping with e-cigarettes by LeCig. With LeCig e-cigarettes' revolutionary microelectronic technology, rechargeable battery, and unique replacement cartridges, you'll get all the satisfaction of smoking, but no smoking hazards. Choose from a wide variety of our new American-made Vapriate e-liquid flavors at LeCig.com, spelled L-E-C-I-G.com. Or call 870-518-4307. That's 870-518-4307. LeCig e-cigarettes for today's modern smoker. Warning, e-cigs may contain nicotine, an addictive substance known to the state of California to cause birth defects or cancer. Please be aware of the risks associated with e-cigs prior to use. You must be 18 years or older to purchase.
Do you know which 37 crucial food items are going to fly off the shelves when the next disaster hits? If you don't, you and your family may be without food and waiting in long food lines after a big disaster strikes. You would be surprised how many people don't have these food items right now. 123SurvivalPlan.com has set up a For Patriots Only video with inside information on the 37 food items that will sell out first when the next disaster strikes. The video on 123SurvivalPlan.com has crucial information you and your family need to prepare for any disaster, natural or man-made. And you won't have to be afraid of going hungry or being sent to a FEMA refugee camp. See the video that over 1 million other smart patriots have already seen in the last 4 months. Prepare now. Go to 123SurvivalPlan.com and learn which 37 food items you should hoard. Easy to remember, 123SurvivalPlan.com. Again, that's 123SurvivalPlan.com.
This is not America, my friends.
This is not America.
Everything this government does is illegitimate at the highest levels.
Little piece of you.
And people have to make a decision who they're going to serve.
Little piece of me.
You can rationalize by fear and think, oh, I'll just go along with the system, I'll be okay. No, you're not.
This is not America.
This is a great test that we're living right now. I can't tell you how important tonight, 7 o'clock, PrisonPlanet.tv, and InfoWars Nightly News is going to be. We're going to do this segment. The official radio show will end, but still audio and video streams. I'm going to do 5 extra minutes so I can get to everybody that's holding. Bob Chapman, again, is our guest. Let's talk, as he is every Friday in the third hour. Kevin in New York, you're on the air. Thanks for holding.
Fine.
Hey, Kevin, welcome. Kevin's listening on the internet, I think, or the radio and doesn't know. We're going to go back to Kevin in a minute. Let's go ahead and talk to Nancy in California. Nancy, you're on the air.
Hi, Alex and Bob, and I just want to thank you for your most excellent work.
Thank you.
And I have a question about mortgages, and I'm wondering, what will the banks do with mortgages if and when the dollar is further devalued or crashes? Can the mortgages be paid off with devalued dollars, or will the mortgage balances be revalued? And I'm wondering, I have some cash. Should I pay off my home now and leave me with very little cash? Or I'm just confused about
it. Well, it's
that,
always so hard to give individual advice because we don't know all the factors. But personally, Bob, what would you do off of her question?
Well, first of all, I take the cash and I buy gold and silver. Second of all, I wouldn't worry about paying off anything. Third of all, nobody knows what they're going to do until we get there. What is get there? When the dollar becomes devalued and you have less purchasing power than you had before, and still the outstanding bill is higher.
What about the question about it? Because I'm always wondering that. I mean, they've done different things. What about, let's say you got a $300,000 mortgage, you owe $200,000 on it, and they devalue the currency so it's easy to pay off, but a lot of times they just increase the mortgage and have some national mortgage holiday. How do you see that happening, Bob?
Well, as I was saying, the people, the bankers, the government, in all likelihood, would say you have to pay off the original amount. And were you to have to do that, you would lose the house. And the reason they would do that is that they could nationalize housing that way.
Yeah, I understand. Some people can't pay it. I'm saying if the dollar's devalued, will they increase the note of the house?
No, it'll stay at the same level, but the dollar will have far less purchasing power.
So they'll keep the mortgages in your research at the same amount they are now?
That's right. And that way you'll lose your home. They got $6.8 million right now in foreclosure default. And over the next 3 years, they'll have about $11 million. And let's say 3 years from now, hypothetically, the dollar dropped two-thirds in value. Well, they'd end up maybe with another 11 million homes, and the ones that they didn't have, they'd make offer for, own them all, and then they tell everybody in the country that we own them all, and if you want to live in them, you pay us rent. But with that comes instructions as to where you're going to live, and so on and so forth.
By the way, the feds are already doing that. They're already saying they may nationalize a bunch of houses and do that. And then under federal rulings, they say you don't have rights. They can come in and inspect what you're doing because you live in a government house.
That's right. And I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I wrote about this 8 years ago when I predicted the fall of Franny and Fannie and Freddie. And there was the nationalization thereof. That's what's happened. Now, the next step is total nationalization of homes.
All right, stay there, Bob. We're going to do five more minutes. Main show's over. God bless you all. We're going to come back in overdrive, InfoWars.com only. See you tonight, 7 o'clock.
Thank you for listening to GCN.
7 Central, PrisonPlanet.tv.
GCNLive.com today.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Fix bayonets. We are now entering overdrive with your host, Alex Jones, broadcasting live from the front lines. If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance.
That's right, and we are back live, ladies and gentlemen, taking some more of your calls. Let's go ahead and talk to Phil in Ohio. You're on the air with Bob Chapman. Go ahead.
Hi, bless you and yours, both of you. Real quick, Alex, you've had a number of information pieces on county sheriffs. I have a question, I guess. In the Constitution, it says the sheriff is a principal authority. for those that are in the know and informed and all that, they need to get together and work together. Can't the county sheriff form, organize, direct, and probably most important, arm a militia?
No, that's right. And that's right. And then the feds will have trouble demonizing it and making it look bad. You know, the way the open carry folks have done things is the right way to flaunt our rights so that people learn they're ours. We're going to exercise them, back off, and stop acting like they're bad. The Second Amendment is not put in a black bag like it's a porno magazine. And you're absolutely right. The feds are trying to get rid of sheriffs all over the country. They've got the cities trying to take those over, or the states abolish them. And it's just like taking the senators away from the states and making them generally elected, not appointed by the legislature. It's all about getting rid of the states, and sheriffs are a key in the fight. Bob Chapman?
I agree completely, and it's always been that way. And the gentleman's correct. We've got to get these sheriffs to work together, and they are. They're having meetings, and they know at these meetings it's discussed that what does the federal government want us to do? Well, they want them to do you to do all their dirty work so they don't have to do it.
All right, well said, Phil. Thank you. I'm going quick here. Michael in Canada, you're on the air with Bob Chapman. Go ahead.
Hey, I just have Mitchell. A quick question for you, Alex.
Yeah.
What's your opinion on this whole Occupy Wall Street movement that's happening like across like U.S. right now?
Well, it's an incredibly complex issue. George Soros-controlled groups, since in the news today, put the call out 6 months ago that in October, if you didn't like the corruption of Wall Street, show up and protest. They left it nebulous to get everybody out there. Then they had the media put attention on it and say, we love Obama, give us communism, which didn't really speak for Occupy Wall Street. Now it has come out that from the beginning, George Soros and others have been trying to steer it. But because they failed to steer it, they have a pincer attack of shutting it down while still controlling the elements of it. And here's WorldNet Daily today. Occupy's nerve center, staffed by Soros activists, professional radicals caught red-handed running so-called leaderless movement. So that's an article right there. Bob Chapman, a final word on that.
Exactly the way you depict it. I think the only good thing that's come out of it is a lot of people attended these different meetings and gave their two cents worth about the middle of the road or slightly to the right version of what they were doing and how they were wrong. And I think they had quite an impact. And so I think that was positive, although we can't control what's positive. People went out and did it. And I think that's wonderful.
Yeah, and so Obama and Soros are trying to flush their creation down the toilet. And again, folks, and I appreciate your call, caller from Canada. You know, my point is that people, everything isn't simple. Like, is it good or is it bad? Like, is the U.S. military good or is it bad? No, military's good. At the top's run by evil people. Yeah, I mean, again, this is a little more sophisticated. And so there's no doubt I get criticized for even saying it's got Democratic operatives in it, which it does. Let's just be honest about it. They know revolution's coming. They want to try to steer it, Bob.
That's correct. That's absolutely correct. And I'm glad they're flushing it. It gives the people who want to demonstrate on their own the opportunity to do so.
Exactly. Again, you don't need to go out because the adbusters and told you to, and then we're going to call to get rid of the middle class and just Wall Street's bad, period. No, the mega banks are bad. They're the monopoly. It's going after real free market. All right, Bob, great job. Great to have you with us. Lord willing, we'll see you back live next Friday. Everybody else, see you tonight, 7.
For centuries, silver has been used as a powerful natural antibiotic. And as a listener to this station, you probably already know the benefits of using colloidal silver. With so many websites to choose from, finding a reputable patriotic company with great products at affordable prices.